Hi, Mr. Rich Voss. Come sit down. Have a seedy doodle.
I don't just come to a party.
Exactly.
You know, I wasn't a
lemon party.
I wasn't. You know.
Hi, Rich.
But God, if we couldn't smoke in Central Park, can you imagine what a nightmare that would have been?
God. Pole smoke.
Get that bad taste out of your mouth.
When I ate the girl's ass.
Yeah, right. Were you smoking at the time?
Just I was
licking ashes on her back.
He's eating her ass. It looks like a kid in candy. I'm getting blown. He's eating her ass. And we're driving home. I go, you have fun? I got my pants dirty.
No, really? I said my legs are sore because I was squatting. And you know the story. And he goes, why didn't you kneel on me? Because I didn't want to get my pants dirty. She ate someone's ass.
What were you like, fucking like a catcher?
Yeah.
Just like squatting down.
You had to see the look on the girl's face. You know, she's blowing me, and all of a sudden, a tongue goes in her ass, and her eyes just lit up, man.
That's all you saw, too, because she was a black girl, and it was late. Just two eyes.
And it was great, because when we were done, she was home.
You ate a black girl's ass in Central Park.
She was so hot.
We met her outside of SOBs. She was hot, man. She recognized this is how fucking zeros we were. She knew Voss from the fucking the Boston Comedy.
Yeah. Wow.
Comedy Club.
Yeah, wait a minute. I go to her.
And then how do you just break the ice with, hey, can you blow me in the park
one
day in the merry, merry?
He's going for the long tongs. What happened, we were going to eat bagels, and she recognized me. And then she came with us to eat bagels, and we said we're going to go up to the Peep Booth.
No, we got the bagels on 54th. That's 54th and Broadway was the bagel place, and the Peep Booth place was fucking three doors down.
Oh, that's convenient.
Yeah, you get whitefish. We're up the floor of the Peep Booth.
Put a little schmutz on your bagel.
We would go fucking... Voss really was fucking juice squared. He would take me for whitefish bagels at 2 in the morning. That was the fucking greatest.
Wow.
They were good bagels.
They were.
Ooh, wonderful.
Just two guys in love back then.
I give a shit about the bagels. How'd you get the girl to blow you in the
park? Meeting at
the
diner on Route 22. We would meet at the fucking diner and go into the city together and get bagels after. And one night a black girl recognized him and we took her for bagels.
Yeah.
Then he took her into a peep booth and got kicked out.
Okay, so you took her into a peep booth. Okay, that kind of lets everybody know the kind of personality the girl
has. But then we were standing, we got kicked out of there. And then we were standing like between my car and like a newsstand.
Yep.
And she has a skirt, and I'm making out with her. I put my finger under her skirt, and I'm fingering her, and he's standing behind her.
Does she have panties on under her skirt, or have those been removed in the people?
No, I went under them. I don't.
Oh, okay.
And he's standing behind her, just squeezing her ass like it's a Charmin's commercial.
And I squatted down. And I just started kissing the cheeks of her ass a little bit and caressing them.
You were feeling it out, like, is this okay?
Broadway and 54th Street, we were parked. It was right between Voss's car and a newspaper. And didn't Bud Friedman go by?
Yeah, we missed Bud Friedman.
Bud Friedman.
Yeah, because they did that show at Caroline's that night.
Bud Friedman was by.
Did he see us?
But he didn't. I don't think we were. I think I had stood up and we were just standing there at the moment and we just like, wow, Bud almost caught me fucking my face in her dumper. This fucking monocle.
Jimmy, one thing that fascinates me, how did you know that would even be okay with anyone else, like with Voss or
Voss,
the black
I knew
chick?
It would be okay. But with her, because, you know, Voss was a good team player. He got so many chicks back then. He was always trying to get his ugly friend laid. I was the fat chick that he was hanging out with.
We were doing a gig in Harrisburg or somewhere, and I was begging the maid to take him in the closet.
And look at my dick.
And just look at it.
Yeah, just look at
it. Yeah, because if she looks, that's the start.
Or she was a waitress or a maid or something. I don't know what she was.
She was a waitress.
And
the maid was the was Sofitel. I raped her.
Yeah, well, you're in charge of the IMF.
Oh man.
So you how'd you get into the park? Like, why'd you go from the car to the park?
It was just a place to be alone. I lived in New Jersey. Yeah. He lived in New Jersey, and it
was the car was too small.
No. Yeah, we were driving around after she busted. And I go, where are we gonna go? We went to. It was warm out, and we climbed the wall of Central Park. She went over with she's
like the Warriors
and asshole.
She was actually the radio chick from the movie. Sorry about that, Warriors.
Oh, Jim, I had a little nugget fall out. Sorry about that.
So it was fun, man.
You went into the park and found a little.
I think he made out with her and she started sucking his dick and I just fucking went to town and ate her ass and her pussy. I was a trooper.
Wow,
she blew me too though.
Oh, she did?
Yeah.
On stage.
To fruition?
Yeah, she was. I don't remember if I came or not.
Huh?
I don't remember if I blew a load or not.
On the other night on stage, I told the story. Matter of fact, the one about I was working at Caroline's, and I met these. I was staying at, for some reason, at the Marriott, or they were at the Marriott across the street.
Yeah, they were one of the Marriott employees.
I met these girl ladies. One, if we were lucky, was a 2. The other one was a -7. So Norton's working Dangerfields, and I call him. I said, I got these 2 ladies. I never seen a guy get across town so quick, okay? I'm telling you, it was like he was passing the Batmobile, right? And he, so we go back up to this fucking, I don't know, it's just a quick reference. It's early still, okay? He went for the long tongs.
And
he's a pro. I love my bank. So these ladies are horrific. Horrific.
He knows the story.
Yeah.
Oh, you know the story? So I'll tell it. Well, there's always a new listener.
I like a new angle on, you know,
the story.
So you fuck some pigs?
No.
I was trying to hit on the fucking, we went to their room and I was hitting on the fucking, the -7. And Voss takes the 2 in the fucking bathroom and she was getting married in a few days, like her fourth marriage. Remember that? Yeah. And, I was striking out with fucking awful. So after he was done, I went in with the girl.
I begged her. Well, I didn't beg her. I told her you just got out of rehab and you haven't been.
Oh, did you tell her that?
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I thought she liked me, man.
How are you getting turned down by the fucking -7?
Well, it's a -5.
Yeah, I'm not exactly an 11.
That must have pissed you off, though, this fucking bitch.
Yeah, I was so irritated. But he was in the bathroom and whatever. I tolerated her. And then I went into the bathroom after. And I actually made out with her. And I don't know why. I was just horny.
And she had...
But that's not the kicker.
You had cum in her mouth?
No.
Well, she was blowing me and stuff.
Yeah.
And then I asked Norton, did you make out with her? And he said, yeah. I go, well, she had her tongue up my ass.
Yeah, she ate his ass. I said to Voss, I think before I asked him, like, did she blow you? He was like, no, he just fooled around, or I just fucked her. Like, whatever. I forget what he said. But he indicated that she didn't do anything with the mouth that I would object to.
Right.
And then afterwards, I learned the error of my ways. Is that indeed?
Man.
That was so much fun back in the day when you could just get pussy. Like, if I was single,
yeah,
being older and what's going on, I don't know if it's as easy to get laid. I mean, when I used to do comedy, it was like girls would just come up to you out of nowhere. You know, I remember one time I was working a gig in Somerville, and if Bonnie's friend is listening, Maria, this is way before I was married, okay?
Actually, I have to make an excuse now.
I remember this girl came after the show. Within 5 minutes, she was blowing me in the coat room. It was like, and she was a hottie. And I was horrible. I had bad teeth and long hair, you know. Shouldn't you be running for breakfast?
Oh, damn.
Yeah, breakfast feet.
There's the famous photo, yeah. And you were getting blown in, like, coat rooms and...
It was just crazy, girl.
Just horny chicks. What years were these about?
Early 90s, right?
Was it early 90s?
Well, 20 years ago, I guess. 20-something years.
And were they quality girls? Or
yes.
Really?
Yes. When I was in Vegas, I picked up this girl. I was working with Jay Moore. Brandy, she was smoking.
I remember
In Reno, I'm at the show, and this girl's here with her mom. She's a dancer. A 10 between shows. And she says to her mom, we're going to take a while. I go up to my room and, you know, everything. Next, you know, I did it. It was insane.
What happened? You're just going, you know, did she blow you? Did you fuck her in the ass? Did you come inside of her and make a baby? What happened?
One girl, I was in Vegas fucking this girl, and I wanted to gamble so bad when I was fucking. I wanted to shoot that.
So did she.
So I told her I was going, I swear to God, it didn't happen, but I'm going down for a bagel. She goes, if you get me one, you can fuck me in the ass. That's for a bagel.
Wow,
that's
a bargain.
I would have got her a bagel.
Yeah, of course.
You know.
Yeah.
Huh? No, I lost the money. I couldn't get her the bagel. No,
atrocious.
No, I wouldn't do that. No, just fucking some stranger on the ass. That's disgusting.
Okay, yeah, well, I get the drift.
So I don't know back then. I don't know if comics
here's
now.
The story. It was another guy, and Voss actually said that to him. Fuck me in the ass if I get you a bagel.
Worst possible scenario.
Yeah. I put the bagel right up my ass.
Oh, yeah.
You're a smart guy.
I try to be.
He said that in the mirror so many times.
I don't know if, how I can make this scenario sound legitimate, but say you lived on a cul-de-sac, right?
Uh-huh.
Or a warm sack.
You had, say like...
Cold sack, I'd hate
just
that.
A two-bedroom house, a little two-bedroom house.
Uh-huh.
And all the houses around you were like six and seven bedrooms. But everybody on the block hated you. They all hated you.
Mm-hmm. The Waltons or something?
Okay. Then one family gets kicked out of their house, right? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And the mortgage company calls you and says, you have to take that family in, but they're not going to recognize you're the owner of the house. Would you take them in?
The fuck is this?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Talking about Israel's. And the borders.
Oh, I gotcha. No, I wouldn't take them.
Thank you.
Unless they were blowing me and eating my ass. I don't know. I like his analogy. Well,
that took me from the turnpike to the tunnel.
You thought it up yourself or you heard that?
I thought of that one. Yeah. Just my analogy. Just insane, the things that... I like
that your Jew comes out when these national events happen. And
well, because you hear, well, it's crazy. You know what? Here's my theory.
Uh-oh. Strap in.
Well, the Arab world is not too happy with our president after what we did in Pakistan. You know, Pakistan's pissed off. Other Arab countries. So how do we appease the Arabs?
I don't think anyone's that pissed off, to be honest, that we killed bin Laden. A lot of them hated him, and I think everyone knew that he had to be. They all knew we were coming after him.
Yeah.
That's a legit
no
shot.
No surprise.
Yeah, but to go into their country.
Oh, fuck Pakistan. What are they going to do?
Well, you're right. Nothing. But they're still pissed off. You don't think we'd be pissed off?
If
we caught operatives in this country.
But are they pissed off or do they have to say they're pissed off because they have radicals
in their
country?
Yeah, they got crazy people over there.
Okay, so to appease them, we go, all right, what can we do to
So jump on Israel and say that you want to give up some of their land.
Yeah.
So that's what you think Obama's doing?
Well, I don't know. It's not going to hurt his PR. You know, there's a lot of Arabs in this country that will be voting in 2012 or whenever it is again.
I think there's more Jews that would vote for Obama than Arabs. I think so. Don't Jews tend to be a little more on the Democratic side?
Oh, yes. But there's only how many percentage of Jews compared to Arabs in this country are there?
I think there's a lot more Jews than Arabs.
By the way, you lost me on the smart theory when you said how many percentage.
Whatever.
I just have my Voss translator on. I'm not even like hearing
it. There's 3% Jews in this country, so you say maybe 1% of them or 1.5% are voters. 1.5% of this country are Jewish voters.
Yeah,
how many Arabs are there in this country?
Exactly. I don't think it's more. And if you look at a state like New York, which is a pretty important state democratically, you got a lot in the city, especially you got a pretty high Jewish voter base that you don't want to alienate by turning your back on Israel.
Well, by him saying that, you don't think he's
appeasing the friggin'...
Well, you don't think he's destroying his relationships with the with
the
Hebrews?
I think he is, but I think it's out of, you know, that this stupid political correctness bullshit and his love for the Muslims and wanting to appease them. Yeah,
appease the Muslims.
Yeah, yeah, but not so much appease them for things we've done, but I think it's just a constant thing of just he'd rather the Muslim world love him than anything else, it seems. That just seems to me. He's constantly doing things where it's like we got to have, you know, Muslim fucking, some kind of Muslim appreciation day. The guy, I don't care what he calls himself now religiously. He was raised a Muslim. I think he still has that. Wants to, you know, give him a little boost wherever he can. Much to the chagrin of the Jew.
Where doesn't he? I mean, doesn't he have advisors? I mean, they
no,
couldn't. I mean,
not a one.
None. He's not
he
listening.
He just
to any,
goes
I mean,
all alone, and no, I have no idea what he has.
Well, he has
and he's
his
got a bunch of clowns
staff.
Around
I
him.
Mean, yeah, when I watch 24, the presidents always have millions.
That's how he gets his information. Look, I have to eat this sandwich.
Have to take a break, yeah.
This sandwich. So we're going to take a break, and we'll be back with the lovely and talented Rich Voss, who, where are you going to be?
I'm going to plug this date. It's a couple weeks down the road because I haven't been. It's in Buffalo. I haven't been to Buffalo in about 6 or 7 years.
Oh, wow. So they'll forget the material.
I got tons of. I'm going to come.
Of course they.
I'm coming out with my third CD.
I know, Rich.
It's called Nietzsche's Music Hall. It's a music hall.
Wow, is that a hard word for you?
Nietzsche's, is that it?
No, I'm not going to tell you.
How do you say that? How do you say it?
Oh, no, he didn't say that. Let me see the word.
Say it again. Say it again, Rich. I'll tell you if you got it right.
Nietzsche's.
Nietzsche's is one of those.
It's Nietzsche's?
Yeah, not Nietzsche's.
Have you heard of it? It's a music.
No, but
it's
I know
a music venue.
The word.
It's a music venue.
So you can't really say Nietzsche's if you. It was Nietzsche.
It's Nietzsche.
I could say what
else. It's Nietzsche's.
Yeah.
Nietzsche's, dummy.
That's what it is?
Nietzsche, yes. Like fucking the philosopher.
Oh, yeah. That's what Bonnie told me last
night.
Not
Nietzsche's. Is it Nietzsche?
Nietzsche's.
Nietzsche's, yeah.
Nietzsche.
Wait, hold on.
Try it.
Nietzsche. Cheese. Yeah. No, that was a bad one.
Wow.
Neat cheese. Oh, perfect. Perfect.
That wasn't perfect.
Wow.
What happens to the inside of your mouth when you make that sound like ch?
Yeah, ch, ch.
It's my jaw shifts.
Where does it go?
Shifts into neutral.
Yeah.
neat cheese. No, that was perfect. That was good right there.
It wasn't
there.
Good.
Yeah. Yes, it was.
It wasn't.
Yes, watch. Hold on.
Oh, my God.
Neat cheese.
See, it gives
that one.
You're punching off the fly.
It's not that bad.
It goes instead of
okay, well, I'll be in cheese. Buffalo at Nietzsche's.
Hey, there you go.
Nietzsche's. Nietzsche's. Make a hard sound. Nietzsche's.
Friday.
It's like cheese
June
on your 17th. Knees or something.
17th.
Stupid. My new nightclub's open.
Yeah, what's it called?
Scandals.
Of course it is. Nietzsche's.
Scandal nightclub.
Yeah? Scandals. What's the motif? Like what
just
is
to
it?
Make money.
No, not motive. Oh. What's the what like the decorative what's the vibe? The
bunch of seashells and stuff.
Oh yeah?
And like nets like you caught whales in them.
Oh, so it's kind of a nautical kind of an atmosphere?
Everybody behaves.
Why is it called Scandals then?
It's a bunch of scandals happening.
I would think if it was Scandal, is it like dark, dimly lit? Like Rich.
Thank you. Not a lights are all on full blast.
That's not much scandal can happen.
That's
there.
Why they're on there, because everybody's got some scandals.
Well, the name alone will bring it in.
Yeah.
Chip, I'm sure.
But they messed up the sign, though.
Yeah.
They forgot the C. So everybody's just been wearing sandals. I got to get that fixed.
Yeah.
I'm going to spell it with a K. Scandals.
But that's
K.
But that seems to go with the shells and the netting and the beach kind of thing.
But notice the K is going to be like, there's going to be a K over it with an arrow in. Scandals.
So you don't have to bring back the original sign, right?
Yeah. My friend made it.
Well, we'll all look for it. Thank you, Chip.
You have any ketchup?
Yeah, we'll get some ketchup and I'll be right back.
Virus, Sirius XM. This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Opie and Anthony.
Well, today, it's Anthony, Jimmy, and Rich Voss. Thank you, Rich.
I gotta hand it to you that you can do this. I woke up at 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
As I'm walking downstairs, so have my coffee, I'm going... Yeah, I think I'm going to blow this out.
Yeah.
I'm going in my head, do I do it? And I'm sitting drinking it. I go, I'll make my decision by 5:30.
Yeah, you know? That is my mental conversation with myself every single morning.
Yeah.
The second the alarm goes off, I try to think of a way, and it only lasts for a few seconds, but it's every morning I try to think like,
maybe I could just call someone. Yeah. Maybe I, is there, you know, I'll call Travis and maybe he can like square things out with this one or that. And then I realize it's just futile. I'll get in fucking trouble up the ass. I'll fuck it. So I'm just like, I get out of bed. And then once you're up and out of bed, then you're going to work. But when I'm just laying there and the alarm goes off, the paramount thing on my mind is I don't want to function this early in the morning.
Well, here's the difference is, okay, it's worthwhile for you to come in look at your house. I have nothing to gain or lose. Maybe four people will come see me in Buffalo.
Maybe.
Maybe four.
Right.
Nothing but negative printing all over the place. Did you hear how he talked? Did you hear what he said? Oh, look, he messed that one up. Ooh, what O&A comic did you hate and now you love? Going back from song break. Go anyhow. You know what I mean? So there's not a lot to gain out of it. You know, except having fun and hang on a radio.
That's true. But, you know, as far as financial things go or anything, there are some clubs that I'm sure the plugs are... work good for others,
for who?
Maybe not so much.
For who, Bobby?
No, I don't mean people. I mean
the best for me. O&A is like Philly, obviously, or Stress Factory, and Utah was good. Salt Lake.
Wait, was that because I just got offered that gig? I turned it down. I didn't turn it down, but I'm not going to do it yet. Is that good?
Yeah, it's O&A? Good. Those O&A fans in Utah, I mean, I don't know if the guy's going to have me back. I think he's pissed for some reason. I don't know.
A lot of fat people in Utah.
Because
Stop chewing the gum.
The only thing I could think of, here's the deal, why he might be pissed. Didn't I tell you the story about the bonus? This is the only thing I think he could be pissed at me. If it was a small club I did. If I did over a certain amount of people, I got an extra $500.
Nice.
Right? So I came up 10 people short.
Oh,
so I bought the tickets at 10 a piece. That's $200. So I got a $300 bonus.
It's an, right? You
I bought the tickets.
Shyster.
Why? Because my expenses, my travel, everything.
Is there a drink minimum?
Well, he's got three clubs. He's got three clubs. Hold on.
Is there a drink minimum?
I don't know.
Here's why that matters.
Yeah.
Because, is it tickets or total gross on the fucking... Here's why I'm asking. Because if it's tickets sold and people in the club, then the club owner might go, well, that's fucking... I've lost a minimum of two drinks on every one of those because there's a minimum.
Yeah.
But then again, if it's total gross on the box office, the drink minimum is irrelevant.
Well, I don't... All I know is...
Are you booking yourself?
All I know.
No, here's the thing. Club owner's cool. He listens to O&A.
So now what happened, though? Did he pay
you?
Why would he be mad at that?
He should tip his hat to you.
Here's the thing. The two things that could be. All I know is I killed there. It was a great club. And it was great. I did the... There's three rooms. He has three rooms. Two of them are like big rooms. Three or something, 100-seaters, I think. I mean, Bellamy was there the week I was there in the big room. So it's
how big was the room? That's the big room? How big was the room you did?
It was a small room. Remember Jay Moore was talking about it. It's a great room. It's in downtown Utah. So the only thing I could think of, because he was at the club, one of the shows, and I was killing, is the bonus or the fact that I was saying to a waitress, come back to the hotel with me. But, you know, I'm only messing around. I'm just being a scumbag because I'm married. You know, if she said yes, I would have panicked. But maybe he's not mad at me. Maybe he just doesn't answer emails after. You know, I wrote back to him going, I had a good time. I hope, you know.
How did he know you bought the tickets?
The manager told him. I told the manager, I said, if I don't hit the number, if I get close, I'll buy the tickets. He goes, yeah. And he told the owner that. So I don't even know. Maybe the owner's not pissed
at me. How many people are sitting? There's a club seat.
The one I did?
No, the one Bill Bellamy did. Of course, the one you did.
You're not going to do that, so it's irrelevant.
No, it's not. I'm trying to wonder.
It's like 100 people, the one I did seat. It seats like 100, 110, I think. You know, so, and...
It has some good comics there, though. I'm looking at... Is that them, Wise Guys?
Let me tell you, it was cool.
Kevin Pollak. They have some fucking real...
Yeah.
The other room has got to be bigger than 300 if they're doing Gilbert, they're doing Kevin Pollak. I guarantee the other room is like 550.
No. No, I don't think it's that many. I don't know.
How many shows a weekend?
What am I? Mine was four because I was in the small. I guess it's four, two and two, and one, or maybe one Thursday. I came in early to do radio, and the radio was fun there, too.
Patrice.
The radio guys were great. They got along. Ralphie. Oh, yeah, they're getting.
Patrice, Ralphie. Oh, Jim Brewer's doing it. Fucking Madigan. Aren't they real comedians?
Kathleen Madigan sells out everywhere. And I showed us all.
That's why I loved her in with real comedians.
Well, she buys her own seats.
Yeah.
Well, 10 tickets, big deal. The extra 300 made up. It made up for my rental car.
What'd you do with the tickets? Just throw them out?
Huh? I didn't get the tickets, you fucking idiot. I just bought the seats.
So why did you say, look, give me 300. I missed it by 10.
Oh, well, I didn't
Boston
actually
know why I said that.
Right. He's here.
I don't know. So maybe the guy's not pissed at me. Maybe he just doesn't answer email. All I know is I want to go back to this place.
All I know.
There's one story that's really been bugging me.
What's that?
I know.
This fucking...
This is how jealous I am.
Yeah.
Let me tell you. Okay. I thought he was going over his lines for a TV show or a movie.
Voss is a
boob.
What happens is when we have these prep sheets, we have stories. This one is the New Jersey teen that wanted the prom dress refund, and this story has me fucking out of my mind. So what Travis or one of the guys will do is go over and yellow highlight certain parts of the story. So if we're on the air and we just pick it up and look at it, we kind of can go to the yellow highlight areas instead of reading the whole
thing. Yeah, get the gist.
Makes it a little bit easier. So that's how you would also highlight a script. So Voss thought that I had a script. You're right. It's a show I'm doing.
How does he memorize all those lines? Because it was like four pages.
Wow.
Yeah. But this girl, I just fucking hate. Do you know the story?
No. I've been incommunicado for the weekend.
I just read it last night. She was in New Jersey, and their prom dress has a no refund policy place. Yeah. And it says, like most girls, she was going to the prom. Tragedy struck last week. Her boyfriend of 2 years was killed in a car accident.
Jesus.
It was a two-car crash. She was on his way home from a little baseball team dinner. She bought her $1,200 dress from this fucking, at Freehold's Diane and Company. It's known from that popular Oxygen show, Dress Couture, which I never saw. It sounds awful.
I watch Oxygen all the time.
So she wanted a refund so she could help pay for her boyfriend's funeral expenses.
Wow.
And the mother approached the store, and they said it's against store policy. So they offered her a credit. The mother fucking said that when she showed up to bring the dress back, they were nasty and unsympathetic. And the company goes, no, we didn't do that. Over the phone, they said it's a terrible, tragic situation. Has been spun out of control. It's not we're not trying to be vicious or uncompassionate. But we're faced with tragedy all the time.
What?
Fucking
asshole.
How assholes.
Much tragedy are they faced with all the time?
Probably people getting dumped and broken up with, and my boyfriend cheated on me, and my boyfriend...
Yeah, well, that, then you could say...
That's not
then,
tragedy, then, that's reality. That's
just shit that happens.
They offered to make a donation to the memorial set up, and fuck that store,
give her the $1,200 back.
How much was the dress?
$1,200. What a fucking...
I cough up $1,200.
I'll tell you, if I worked for that store, I would have said, hey, I'll take her to the prom.
But what a fucking... That, it just makes me fucking crazy what scumbags...
Yeah, that is a scumbag.
People are. So maybe I'm wrong. Look, if anybody knows more, and Freehold's Diane and Company is not that type of store, but they sound like fucking shit, if that's the truth.
They offered to make a donation to the memorial fund, but they refused to give a refund.
What fucking scumbags.
Wow, what hell is going on?
Fucking scumbags.
Diane and Company, huh?
What scumbags.
I bet they're getting some shit.
The girl's, her boyfriend is killed? A fucking 16-year-old's boy? It's like... Oh, it makes me fucking so irritated.
I saw that
it's not like your fan base is going to proms. No one's going to go with them.
They're usually out of school by that point.
Their protest page on Facebook now has more likes than their actual Facebook page.
Good.
Yeah.
People should fucking, they should be blasted on Facebook.
$1,200.
Or on Twitter or whatever. It's almost like if you're going to be that big of a scumbag as a company and you can't make, that's that example of not making an exception. The fucking girl's boyfriend is killed. If she didn't want to pay for the funeral. Even if she just wanted her money back on the drugs, her boyfriend's dead.
Is that them?
Mm-hmm. Fucking assholes.
Okay, they look, okay. Oh, they look like fashion people.
Ugh.
Yuck.
We're faced with tragedy.
You know what I mean?
So really, I would love to know how many times every year somebody's boyfriend is killed and somebody asks you for a refund like a week or two before the prom. Yeah. How often does that happen?
Oh, it happens so often we'd go broke if we gave refunds. I'll give her a refund, you fucking pricks.
I say we take a drive and get her the money. We could do it.
Oh, really? Bust some legs?
We could easily just fucking...
No, I said no.
Believe me.
Do a fundraiser.
She will get the money from other people, and this place will get the grief. You know, that's somewhere where somebody should have to fucking apologize. Not this political correct bullshit that everyone apologizes for every day. How about a situation like that where somebody actually fucked with somebody's life like that. Bunch of pricks.
Well, the only way is for people to let them know how fucking disgusting. It's like, that's just, you face these companies, man, and there's no humanity in any of these fucking people. In the airlines, in retail stores, there's just that's policy, that's policy, that's policy, that's policy.
Oh, really? Wait, it can't be changed? Who the fuck made it?
I had a big fight at Target. My wife is sitting at Target.
We knew it would come back to him.
No, about policy. Because I was getting Nicorette gum, and the guy asked for ID.
Of course you were.
Asked for ID. I go, really? I'm not, why?
I know.
But they're so pro. I'm trying to say they're so programmed.
Why were you buying a short ethnic guy gum?
Nobody.
Oh
no, this gum works. Nobody. Nobody. Can make an executive decision. They can't. That's why they have those jobs. That's why they're just so stupid. And I was agreeing with you, but yeah, I haven't.
No, I'm teasing, man. But the airlines are like that. Like the flight attendants, no one can make. Somebody tweeted me about Continental or something. They get upgraded to first from Tampa or something.
Mm.
I don't know if this is just what someone told me. They get upgraded to first class. I guess they were frequent flyers. And the airline, for whatever reason, didn't have the first class meals. Like, I guess they had forgotten, or somebody forgot to put the thing on, or they put the wrong thing on. Oof. And they made them buy the meals from the back.
Ugh. What?
Continental is just a fucking, has become despicable. Yep. They're terrible. All these companies are just shit.
Yeah, and they do cover it under this blanket of, well, it's policy. We can't, like, no one can make a decision anymore. The person on the floor, they hire people where you can't just, you know, you hired someone, you trust them to do their job. How about they can make a decision every so often and go, you know, I kind of felt this out, brought a little humanity into the situation. Not just ones and zeros, and we could do this.
It's this. I'll tell you what. It's this thinking where there's no winners or losers. Everybody's the same. So if they make an exception for one person, then they have to make the exception for
and
everybody.
You know
no, they don't.
You don't. And you make ugly fucking prom and bridesmaid dresses.
Yeah.
You fucking those dumb things that they wear once. Get cum all over.
They're made
throw away.
A nickel in some sweat house somewhere.
Yeah, some fucking Chinese.
Yeah.
Bunch of kids are putting together crepe paper and cheap material. Yeah.
I was on Continental, and these kids are coming from a school trip or whatever.
Yay!
You know, it's just a bunch of them. Maybe 16, 17.
Paul.
And there's a ton of them, and they're walking, and the flight attendant,
they're getting molested.
The flight attendant, some black male, first of all, angry, he should be, he's a flight attendant at
Did
probably
he seem a
40.
Little effeminate?
No, he was like,
oh,
everything else failed, or I lost everything, I have to do this type gig. So the kids are taking time to get, they don't fly all the time, they don't know, and he's yelling at them. Put your bags up. Do this. Yell. And I said to him, I go, hey, maybe if you'd help him, things would speed up instead of yelling.
And he went, motherfucker.
And he wanted to throw me off the plane. He got mad. He goes, yeah, I'll get you thrown off. Why? For basing my opinion?
But that's the problem with these fucking scumbag flight attendants is like they don't make legitimate decisions between a guy who's drunk and a threat to the flight and a problem and a guy legitimately criticizing them. They've gotten so spoiled they think they're above
being criticized
legitimately.
Criticizing a member of the flight crew in any way, shape, or form is a terrorist act.
Yeah.
They'll fucking, zip strip your hands, lay you in the aisle, and land the plane at the closest airport.
I had it one time where I was going to...
Maybe in downtown Utah, like Rich said. Downtown Utah.
Yeah. Utah.
Really? The state? Of Utah?
Did he say that?
Downtown Utah. Well, that's been coming in like crazy.
I didn't catch that.
Yeah.
I was wondering why you obsessed on that. I'm like, this
guy. Downtown Utah.
Downtown New Jersey.
Yeah. Downtown New Jersey. Whatever.
Okay. Downtown Schenectady. Well, you want to throw your own things in.
Oh, Chip. That would work. See?
But there was enough time passed in that. That the statute of limitations.
The statute of limitations, of course. We always remember that one because it's up on the wall.
The statute of limitations.
Statue of limitations.
It's just a statue of Voss's mental capacity. Because it's limited.
It is. You call Continental had me on hold for 45 fucking minutes. And then, I'm not lying, then someone got on the phone and I got cut off another 40 minutes.
Oh, that is
I'm sorry, it's because of the merger. Oh, really? Then hire more fucking people to answer your phone.
When you have to go through that automated shit and then you get cut off, and then you have to go through it all over again. You know you're never going to get the same person.
Oh, you
so now you got to go through the whole bullshit that you went through already.
I don't know how, like, at least if I have a bad experience with the company, I know that I can talk about them on the radio, or I know I can Twitter to 100,000 people. Again, yeah. It may not change. It's not gonna. I'm not gonna
show
do,
off.
I'm not gonna. But I mean, it's.
No,
I'm not gonna fucking break the bank at Continental. But I know it will cost them a little bit of business or it will, whatever.
Some aggravation.
I don't know how regular, like I should say, people without those avenues do it. I don't. Yeah. I understand why people throw punches. Yeah. I understand why people fucking attack employees.
They lose their fucking minds. Yeah.
Of these companies because they're just terrible and they don't deal with you with any humanity.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if you ever dealt with a health insurance company. Well, when we switched our health insurance, I had to bring it down. It's like $20,000 a year. So I sent two payments, but they put them on my old policy, not the new one. So I get a cancellation letter. I go, well, I sent the payments. They go, well, we put them on your old policy. So I go, well, you made the mistake, not me. So now I have to go fax some stuff, document stuff, do all this shit because of their incompetency, if that's the right word.
It's not, of course.
It's close to their incompetence. No, they're incompetent.
See at the end.
All right. But you can't, because there's nobody.
Like being in third grade.
Here's the thing. There's nobody. You made it that far? There's nobody that cares because they're not invested. They're not invested.
Yeah, no one gives a shit.
They don't care. So what are you going to do? You're yelling, you're screaming, and you're getting nowhere.
That is the bottom line, is no one gives a fuck about, like, anything, which, you know, I guess I'm in the same boat.
No, but it's like they deal with horrible customers who demand more than they should get. But I'm not a horrible customer. I don't yell. You dropped your mic.
There it goes.
I don't.
Rich's mic.
I'm not unreasonable. Yeah. Like, I won't. I was flying one time, and again, I'm lucky.
Ooh,
I get
magic.
The Tonight Show will, if I go out there, they put me in first. It's part, again, I say that because I don't want you to think I'm showing off. It's literally...
You're fancy.
No, but it's contractual. It's like anybody they fly out for a thing, they put in...
Do you get miles for that every time you fly?
Yeah, you do. But I mean, it's like, it's whatever. It's what they do for everyone, not just me. So I was flying out one time, and Continental, they ran out of the meal. All right, and I know this is white people problems.
White people problems. But here it comes.
I was like, okay, I'll just have like something from Coach. I didn't complain. I wasn't mad. I was like, whatever. Yeah. You didn't have what I wanted for breakfast. I'll just buy one of the, just give me one of the meals from the back. And just like that guy from Tampa, they made me pay for it. They didn't have it. They ran out of stuff, and they made me pay for it. So I'm inclined to believe him. And I said to the woman, I'm like, you should be embarrassed. Your airline stinks.
And then did she have you?
Like, no, we were in midair. So when I fucking paid her with the credit card, she had a male flight attendant standing with her.
Ugh. Like there's going to be a problem.
I wouldn't even look at her. I stuck it up like, here, take pig.
Call a waitress. You should have said waitress.
Take
come here.
Pig.
Call them waitress.
They stink. Airline employees stink.
They do not like being called waitresses.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, in-flight waitress.
A waitress. Excuse me.
We're flight attendants, and we're trained in safety and stuff.
Oh,
there is this attitude that they are untouchable now. You can't complain about the food, the service, anything that has nothing to do with the safety issue, interfering with the flight crew, anything. I mean, you cannot do it, or else you will be perceived as some type of threat, and they can always hold that over your head no matter what you've done.
It really is annoying when they feel that anytime you complain about their fucking shit service, and if you complain legitimately without screaming, you're considered a threat because they don't want to deal with you. For him to say to Voss, I'll have you thrown off the plane, hey, fuck you.
They were going to throw him and Florentino off the plane because Florentino was farting.
Yeah, the farts. Well,
no, that wasn't
that
me.
That is interfering with the flight crew.
That was him on Stuttering John. Oh. Me and Florentino farted. We both upgraded to first going to L.A., I think for VH1 or something. I don't remember what for. And they were spritzing the fucking... They were spritzing like air freshener by our seats.
It just reeked in
it
the whole area.
It was fucking brutal. I'm sorry to go off on a tangent.
And you guys are just laughing your asses
dude,
off.
Dude, the newspapers, all you the flight attendants saw was this. I'm shaking newspaper of us howling.
You know what? You just got to record yourself complaining. If you got a legitimate complaint on an airline or anywhere, and you record it, and then when you get kicked off, or they stop, or you know they land a plane because you're out of hand because yeah. you don't want to pay, and you're in first class, which that's the whole reason of sitting in first class. You're paying that extra money for yeah. food.
Well, I'm not.
And whatever, you know.
But food's part of it, yeah.
Food's part of it, so you yeah. don't have to, you know, sneak in a fucking old sub from the airport.
You can
know.
Bring it in. You don't have to sneak it in.
Yeah, huh? you can actually bring it in.
You can just bring them on. They don't care. Okay. You're allowed to bring food on the plane.
Oh, fuck. You know what I'm saying. Don't, all right, Mr. Particular.
Wait, you said sneak in an old sub.
You like, know what I'm saying. What
submarine. That'd be hard.
Subpar
grinder. That's what I shot yesterday.
The flight crew. I try not to make any issues, even if they are being assholes, because I feel like it's almost like a Seinfeld soup Nazi thing. I don't want to piss them off because they must keep the drinks coming. So if I'm the asshole, then if I.
Yeah,
I won't get service, and I need those Bloody Marys to keep coming and coming. So,
you know how you fucking strike back? You can't yell at them, but I absolutely dismiss them in my dealing with them. Like, I literally, yes, no, I don't look up at them. I'll keep looking down at my food or my iPad. Oh, I'm a that cunt.
I'm a fucking cunt. Piss them off.
But it's only for fucking when they're really rude or awful. It's like, okay, then I'll treat you
yeah.
like the fucking waitress or waiter you are. Fetch.
The, somebody had a, oh, I guess that's gone. The one that had, it was Diane and Company.
What?
Somebody had a problem, their daughter or something, but, what's that one knows about Diane and Company? It's in his town. I know this will probably amount to nothing, but yeah. Adam?
Yes, I'm here.
You've had dealings with that horrid dress company?
Yeah, you know what? They're such scumbags that they were even lying to the press and claiming that they tried to get the money for the dress, like, on Friday night. But the kid didn't even die in the car crash till after they claimed that they were trying to get their money.
Oh, wait a minute, though. But hold on. Was she trying to get the money from the dress back before he died? Like, maybe they broke up?
No.
Okay.
No, that's what they were claiming, just to try to make themselves look
better. Oh, that's what Diane and Company was claiming.
Yeah, Diane and Company was lying just to try to make save face.
Wait, are they saying that the girl wanted the money back and was using the tragedy to get the money back?
Yeah, they were, like, insulted that they thought it was so quick. Like, how could she come in right away to get the money back? But it's because the girl just wanted to help the family pay for the funeral.
Wow. You
know, the upfront expenses.
Yeah, so yeah.
They're even bigger scumbags there because this dress was, like, bought off the rack. They didn't have to special order it. She didn't have it, like, fitted. So they just put it back on the frickin' rack, yeah. You know?
Ugh. And $1,200 fucking dollars for a prom dress?
Yeah, that's, I guess that's...
a fucking rip-off, whatever it is. All right, thanks, Adam. Go to Billy, Billy, because he's got... Billy. Yeah. He's got, like, a similar story about this. Billy!
What's up, guys?
How you doing, man?
Good. Yeah. Just Adam said that the girl tried to get a refund before the kid died. But you know what? The kid died, and this girl's out throwing herself on the news, like, not even a week later. Something a little fishy about that, don't you think?
No, a week later has been enough time. Like, she might have went a couple of days later.
I think it makes sense because she probably, you know, spoke to the family, knew that they couldn't afford it. And she's like, oh, I could take this prom dress back. Yeah. I don't need it.
Plus, the funeral's going to be...
She seemed like a real twat on TV, though.
Well, her boyfriend died. I mean,
she was
dating the guy for 2 years. It wasn't like it was a one-month relationship.
And she's a high school girl, too. So, I mean, that's, you know, when you
get
how does
she seem like a twat?
All high school girls are.
Yeah, to see.
Believe me. All right, man. Thank you. Thank you, Billy. Billy. It's just, you can't... I get more pissed off every day because you just can't get the shit that you're willing to pay for, that you have paid for. Nothing works. Just blatant incompetence everywhere. Oh, sitting right there.
I bought a fucking iPad for $500 and the guy bought
it.
Yeah,
but you put it over your face.
But the guy. Get his chip.
Sorry, Rich. Okay. That wasn't a good one.
Yeah. iPad, $500.
Yeah.
What happened?
I call the guy for technical support, and he's mean to me.
Well, it's pretty self-explanatory.
Yeah. What did you do
wrong?
I'd
be mean, too.
Oh.
I don't think he's mean to you. Are you joking about Danny's bit that he did about you?
No, I was talking about Bobby being my technical support guy. That's why I
brought him. Oh, Bobby.
Why, what bit did Danny do?
Was Bobby mean to you when he was just yelling
at
you?
The first time I called him, he was mean. Like, he's Mr. Fucking Computer, all right? I can't wait till he calls me for health tips.
Fucking Colin had Bobby pegged because I guess because he said Bobby's a tech bully. Like, he teaches you things as a bully.
A tech bully.
And Bobby and Colin were together, and Colin didn't know how to work his computer or something. And Bobby goes, oh, who am I? Who am I? And Colin goes, you're your stepfather, and I'm you when you're seven. I'm like, yeah, that's probably exactly what happened. Bob is a fucking bully.
What was Bob's line? He tweeted that about black chicks.
I'll have to find it to get it verbatim, but he says something like, black women shouldn't wear deodorant on a hot day because it looks like their armpits are eating ice cream.
Fucking funny.
Bobby, he sent me a video yesterday where he's just, did you see that one? Where he's just home alone and there's this lonely song playing and it's about being alone and he's eating stuff and then he just, he hangs himself at the end of the video. It's really twisted.
What is it?
It's Bobby doing this real sick kind of looking all alone at his house, but he's smiling and he's eating. He's just eating and going through his boring life and this really like kind of morbid, lonely song is playing in the background.
System of a
Down. Yeah. And then at the end, he's like got a rope around his neck from the blinds and he just hangs himself.
That's 2 days
it's
later.
So fucking morbid.
His wife's at the Big and Tall shop trying to return.
Trying to return all of his clothes.
Fucking
at the supermarket trying to return the food.
Yeah.
12 briskets.
Exactly. Trying to have floorboard strengthening equipment removed from the house.
The hydraulic system.
I get it, dude, because I'm fat. I got it. Got it, dude.
Dude, I told you I had one more fat in me.
He's in Tampa now. He's coming home today. I kind of miss Bob, yeah.
Yeah, I haven't seen him in a while.
Never thought I'd say that or think it.
Bobby's a good egg.
Yeah, he's kind of a creep.
He's a dinosaur egg.
I was watching that god-awful Billboard Music Awards last night. And you know how award shows and shit, everybody just kind of gets on Twitter and you start going back and forth with shit. I didn't feel that vibe was going on with that award show last night.
I didn't even know it was happening.
I know. I tried to jump in. Like I think I tuned in maybe 45 minutes before it ended. And I tweeted a few things and realized people were actually tweeting back, what are you talking about?
Right. You think they're
like, oh, okay, no one's watching this. I'm not even going to bother.
You would think they would have advertised at least on one billboard around town.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
It's Monday morning. I'm really not allowed to plug. You're lucky I'm here.
Billboard Music Awards is owned by, Dick Clark Productions. And Dick Clark is, you know, ABC guy. So I guess ABC just used this whole thing. Every time they went to break, it was just promos for all their fucking TV shows.
Oh.
There was barely a commercial. It was, you know, every fucking TV show was being promoted. And the big moments, Britney Spears came out. And she sang with, who the fuck she sang with?
Rihanna.
Beyonce. And then later on, she came out. With someone, I could give a shit who it was. That big ass bitch,
Rihanna. She came out with right.
Nicki Minaj.
No, Nicki Minaj, the big ass. Nicki Minaj is fucking like, there's something bizarre going on there because her body, the whole body looks like a normal person's body, with the biggest fucking ass ever on a person of especially of that stature.
I heard she's a bitch too. I had a driver that had driven her. She said she was a fucking nightmare. Almost threw her in the car.
Yeah.
Figures. Let me see, Sam. Turn that thing.
This is an older picture of her.
That doesn't do it justice. Last night she came out.
They say that it's not real.
Oh, they think it's implants?
Yeah.
She had, like, ass implants?
You can see right...
It does look fake. Like, there are pictures of her ass where it looks fake. Like, it looks like there's just too much ass there for waist. It doesn't go from waist to ass right.
She got rolls. She got rolls right. She was standing in front of
it. They just,
that's just the rapper about nonsense. The rappers always need
the
new
one
cars.
Straight down, I think. Yeah, that one. It's like, that makes no sense.
Whoa.
Look, I think she had ass horrible. Implants, right?
That looks like ass implants.
That's what they say.
God, why would she do that? She's trying to have
a big booty. She's trying to attract guys that like that.
Ass implants are fucking awful. I felt a few. They're terrible.
Talking about?
Yeah. You can get ass implants?
Yes.
Hold on. Let me call Bonnie.
Oh, great. She wants to implant one in place for her husband.
in the music. The biggest injustice in the music is when this girl Haley got kicked off of Idol last week. Did you don't watch it.
Oh, my God.
This girl Haley.
No, teenage girl. Huh? I didn't.
This fucking girl could, man, let me tell you, she belted out Led Zeppelin. She was fucking off the fucking hook. I'm telling you, who can sing Led Zeppelin?
Am I the only
like
one? I can't even look at him.
Yeah.
She was off the fucking hook, man.
Off the his hook.
Off the charts, baby.
Oh, God.
Haley, she's my favorite.
Did you cut a rug like while you were listening to her?
Let me tell you something.
23 Skidoo.
Yeah.
When she got kicked off, I broke camp.
Oh, God.
That's before your time, son.
Before my time too.
Well, we used to leave a place. We'd go, let's break camp.
Is that the cool thing to say?
Back in the 70s. In the NOM?
In the 70s. When we were leaving Auschwitz.
Oh, God. So Britney Spears came out and sang with them. It was one of these 20-second deals where she just pops out. At the end of a song and does this. She came out, and you would think for this many years of lip syncing, she would get it down. No. It was so bad that I don't know how she wasn't completely embarrassed to walk out on that stage. And boy, those stump-like legs. She was wearing a black dress. She didn't look as bad as she has looked in the past, but not nearly as good as she has either.
Why can't they just fucking sing?
Yeah, just sing.
How come none of these shit performers can sing live?
That was a lip sync fest last night. They were all like lip syncing. And then Lil Wayne came out with Mary Jane Blige. Mary J. Blige. I don't listen to her shit. She's ancient, too.
Is she old?
Christ,
she's a queen.
Yeah, she's a queen. Mary J. Blige.
How long is this commercial that you have to sit through?
30 seconds.
And they just had to keep putting
Daily
going
Motion
silent.
Is fucking terrible. That website, they stink. I was fucking trying to watch something on there the other day, and I had tried to fast forward through it, and a new commercial started. I just closed it and went somewhere else.
Oh, you fuck.
Look at that ass.
And now she's doing this whole thing with. There's a bunch of other chicks. And then a chicken comes out. A guy in a chicken suit comes out.
Nicki Minaj is crazy.
What is this about?
She's gonna fry it.
Like, what is this?
A lot of people.
There's a chicken suit guy.
Can you fast forward through it, Tim?
Some real comedy writers on that guy.
Like, look at her ass. It's retarded. And now, wait till Britney comes out.
All right, there's a bunch of chicks in jail outfits.
They were just, like, giving lap dances to a bunch of black guys they brought out on the stage.
That's her bit.
What?
That's her bit. She does it in concert.
Oh, it is.
That's saucy.
Look at her. Now they got it. They keep blanking out all the nasty language.
Sure.
Because God forbid we see it. I was more offended by the white chicks giving the black guys lap dances.
You don't like that?
What's up with that?
Yeah.
They showed that. I'd rather hear, nasty language. And now look, big Britney appearance. Look how bad the lip syncing is.
Fucking stinks.
Not for you people at home. Just trust us. It's bad.
All fucking, what's that thing they do?
Auto-tuned. She's trying to like.
Not even close.
Terrible.
Not even close.
There's no energy, so you can tell she's not doing it loudly.
No. Look at her. And she's got stumpy legs now.
But it's like, who cares about these two being together?
Nobody.
The kids.
They had a fake audience, too, close to the stage.
They like put the beautiful people there.
Oh yeah.
So they could make it like, wow, we're partying and having a great time listening. And they're hired.
And they had this bitch singing, lip-syncing in auto-tune music.
And that's it.
Awful.
And that's all she does. All she does.
I guess if you listen to it on the radio, it's fine. But why would anybody watch a live award show?
There's no reason to.
Nothing's going to happen. Some manufactured moment of craziness. Ooh, Britney kissed Rihanna. Ooh. Who gives a fuck? I've watched people having their mouths shit in.
From under the table.
And then Neil Diamond came out because they gave him an Icon.
Did he
award.
Lip sync too?
No, he sang, but it would have been better if he lip synced because his songs, except for maybe the chorus, have become unrecognizable. He's like, you know, singing Sweet Caroline and the beginning is just, I guess he's so sick of fucking singing it.
Sure he is.
That he just pretty much changed the entire way he sings the beginning.
That's why he told the history of the song. That's why he told the history of the song that he wrote it for Caroline Kennedy when she was like 3, so he wouldn't have to sing it again because everybody thought he was a real creep after that.
Did he say that, or is that a legend or myth?
Oh no,
he said that.
He said, did. Yeah. All right, that's kind of funny. Give him that. But it was, he sang "Sweet Caroline" and America. You know, they come into America.
But he sang it at least.
Yeah, yeah. But when he sang America, they just paraded on behind him. It was like 25 black people and maybe 2 white people.
It was all Mexican.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Let me try this up.
Oh, yeah. I can't begin to know it.
Yeah, he's
just talking. But then
I know. His dancing is really terrible.
It doesn't even sound like the song. Wasn't
a spring. Is his,
Spring became. You know what's funny, though?
But look, he's singing, though. Yeah. At least he's singing.
Spring became the summer! You'd all come along. Well, he's old school.
That's because they couldn't find an old album.
But I just love the fact that this old fucking guy is doing a terrible dance, and he's alive.
It is an awful dance. And look at the people clapping behind him, and they don't give a shit.
They don't know who the fuck he
they're
is.
Like, because they're all hired.
Everyone's heard this song. This song. Oh, he's great.
Yeah, there he goes.
Still sounds good.
Oh, yeah. Well, the chorus. He hits it.
She Beyonce?
No, I didn't catch the
no,
Beyonce.
What did she lip sync?
Oh, that
what
was
did she
the night.
Oh, that's the guy that was just in.
Eric
that was
Stone
fucking
Street.
Eric Stone Street.
Oh, I knew he looked familiar.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. But no, I was looking at that guy going, that guy looks familiar. What's he? Oh, he was sitting next to me.
This is great.
I don't like when he does that.
I don't either.
That it don't seem so lonely. With only two. Just sing it the way you fucking did it on the album. When I heard. Don't get all excited.
He's just an old fucking man walking down the aisle. Not auto-tuning like these fucking twats.
He really is.
Good for you, Neil. These fucking twats all auto-tuning and lip-syncing. Boo!
Warm. All right, let's see Beyonce. What did she do?
She had performance of the
night. God damn it, I was enjoying
performance
that.
Performance of the night. Get it for your... do you have it for your iTunes?
No, I don't have it on my...
Did you get iTunes
I have
and it. Download it on your fucking phone?
Oh. Was she singing or lip-syncing?
Oh boy.
I think there were a few parts where she was actually singing, but not for the most
part. Why wouldn't she? Why would she?
What is this? Fucking. And when I
think, I must speak. Oh, she was on Idol.
Oh, they're so self
empowered.
Yeah,
song.
Neil Diamond just walked out.
Oh, really? Shut up. Spread your legs.
How dare you? Women everywhere.
Run the world. Oh,
boo. Oh, look at this horse shit.
Look at that.
She's dancing with her own silhouettes or something. Yeah, a revolution. Meanwhile, she just shows her ass and... Is that the revolution? That guys think chicks are hot? Yeah, wow. What a revolution that is.
All this nonsense, and she can't even sing her own shit live.
Yeah. Great empowerment she's showing there.
And I really
there.
Sound like an old man. I know it. I'm sure people want to strangle me today. Yeah, I apologize.
Me too.
Companies. What happened to good old Neil Diamond? I'm embarrassing myself. We run this mother. Think it's her. This is awful. We run this mother. Give this.
What is it, fucker?
Here we go.
Oh, this mother. She's doing the Charleston, I think.
This is fucking...
What's she doing?
She's at the Cotton Club.
I don't like this.
This is awful.
Oh, everything is so generic. I know. It's all this generic-sounding techno crap. Look, it's a Beyonce army. Look out. This is We're in trouble now.
This is unlistenable and unwatchable.
What is this now coming in? A rapist?
I'll take fucking stupid Neil Diamond snapping in his awful black coat.
Than this.
Please, pay me.
You should only hear this if you're being cooked in a big black pot.
Yeah, Austin, I'm waiting for Charlton Heston to walk up.
See, that's... this is just terrible.
This is awful.
And first of all, this couldn't have been a performance. This is a video?
She's live in front of the video screen.
Okay, yeah, I'm sure she is. It's great. It's very well choreographed.
Oh, my God.
I just don't like the song.
Right, Monty Howard. I've never heard
Howard Woman.
Y'all ready? Are you ready? No. Yeah, there's her empowerment. Just shake your fucking ass and spread your legs and show your pussy. There, yeah, woman empowerment. Oh, God, do I hate this shit. All right, I've had it. It's happened.
Is she really singing there or no?
I don't know. I've only watched it online, so I don't know.
I don't know why that bugs me so much when they lip sync. I shouldn't care, but I do.
Yeah, well...
I guess I like live music, and I like when they make mistakes, and I like when they trip on fucking... It's like it kind of just symbolizes to me what's wrong with, like, people just can't accept an imperfection. They can't accept that it might not be perfect or like on the album, which is why comedy sucks, because they have to fucking sweeten it with laughs. People just can't accept the fact that a joke might bomb or a laugh might not be what you want or a moment might not be what you want.
Record
so they have to
your
fix
act.
It.
Record your act and then just lip sync it so it's perfect.
No, comics
done.
Can't do that. And by the way, we also can't go on TV and just do our jokes as is and have them fucking conveniently just beep out our mouths.
Yeah.
Because these fucking faggot pussy singers can't change their lyrics and they get away with everything.
Yeah.
Well, I guess Eminem's going to say fuck 50 times, so we'll just have to go on a delay so we can beep it.
That's what they did with Lil Wayne, too.
Weezy.
Lil Weezy.
Yeah, Weezy.
Weezy? What the fuck is that
I'm annoying
about?
Myself, by the way. If I'm annoying everybody, I'm annoying myself.
Yeah, you're
what's with
crazy
the Weezy
over
thing?
It's just bugging me. I'm tired.
Yeah.
What do you mean, what's with...
Sam, what's with the Weezy thing?
What's it like? Why is that his name?
Yeah.
Because Wayne Weezy. Lil Wayne. His name is Wayne, so it goes to Weezy. That's his nickname, Weezy.
What do I know about? I don't get it. You know what you need? You do need to go to...
An empty chair, am I right?
Go to Utah. Work there because it's serene. You need a place like that where there's beautiful mountains around, somewhere you could relax.
Downtown Utah.
Downtown Utah, right? And just go there. The owner, you'll love the club.
You know who I really want?
He's really pushing it.
You know who I really want?
The guy just texted me saying he's not mad at me.
Oh, okay.
You know who I really want to see?
I create these things.
You know who I really want to see on this show? It would be great. Someone came out and sang You Light Up My Life and then mocked fucking putting a bag over their head. Greatest story of the decade.
That is a fantastic story.
He was a bad boy.
What a naughty, naughty boy. The guy that wrote the hit song of the 70s, probably the biggest song ever, You Light Up My Life. Debbie Boone singing it here. What a huge song this was.
Carry on, light up my day,
sounds great.
Fill my night
with song.
I'm fucking good.
You got a good voice, man.
I know.
You got why are you not singing?
Oh, is he a fucking bad boy? I forget his name. Oh, Joseph Brooks.
Yes.
He had 82 allegations of sexual assault.
Now lick my sweaty balls. I'm gonna fuck you in the mouth.
He would invite starlets over and drug and rape them.
Really?
Yeah, he was 73.
He's all living off that one song.
You will be molested.
He was molesting 13 women who were lured to his apartment for supposed acting auditions.
Penis, you are never to blame.
Nice. It was a hauntingly beautiful song.
And his son's a piece of shit, too. He's in jail.
Oh, yeah.
He's on trial for attempted murder, right?
Yep. No, he murdered his... He actually murdered his chick.
You can get a doggy style, you can get a lady on your side. Those are your only choices. This is my house, and I get to say.
You ever suck a guy's cock?
Well, that one is.
Goddamn rich cunt! I kill rich cunt!
When it feels so right, 'cause you.
She was very badly raped, you see. Good evening.
Yeah. How did this guy kill himself?
Oh, it was.
It's like not your ordinary run of
the
mill.
No, no,
with the killing.
I'll tell you.
The
mask.
He his head was encased in a dry cleaning bag that had a tube attached to a helium gas tank, and a towel was wrapped around his head and neck.
Oh my
god! It was fucking like MacGyver killed him.
That must have been hysterical, though. It's like,
oh my god, I'm dying! I can't believe it! I can't breathe!
Why the helium?
Because it's not oxygen. He probably didn't want to not be able to breathe anything in. Like, I think if you put a bag over your head, you just suffocate because... Yeah. Like,
how do people do that?
You can't breathe.
Right.
But with helium, you'll be breathing, but your blood's getting no oxygen, so you just kind of pass out, I guess. He must have studied that online or something.
He was very gaunt.
Oh, he looks fucking like a guy that is facing 11 counts of fucking...
No, 82. 13 women. Yeah. His daughter was a fucking... His daughter really hated him, too. Like, she
was 78.
Not quite a great dad. Great father figure.
So, good. That's great. Hmm. That's what should happen. Now that we don't have to put him on trial, we save money, and he's dead.
Yeah.
How perfect.
He's dead. And then, the son is a scumbag, too. He murdered his fucking...
I don't know if he murdered. He's facing charges. I don't know if he did
it. Well, he's in jail. Yeah, he probably did it. I'm just going to go and say he did it. I don't like that innocent until proven guilty thing. Because if I hear enough, I know they did it anyway. Yeah. Whenever I watch that first 48, and you see the perp, they bring him in, and they pretty much get a confession, and all the evidence points to him. And then they go, at the end, they put the thing, he's in jail, awaiting trial, he's innocent till proven guilty. I'm like, no, he's not. I know he did something.
Track record.
Past performance.
That's what track record means.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, exactly. It's a track record.
I thought that was a good record by a group called The Tracks.
No, Chip. My God. I had such ridiculously racist, horrible dreams last night.
Were they daydreams? Just laying awake, looking at the ceiling, hands behind your head, feet crossed, just dreaming of lynching people to fucking...
Smoking a pipe and whittling.
Yeah.
Just, calling out to the fields.
Yeah. Just thinking about making your own strange fruit.
Oh, my God. No, it was really... Now, it's a dream, so, I don't know what they mean. Everyone tries to interpret dreams.
We'll figure them out very quickly.
Well, I'm sure you will. But it's like, it's really fucked up. Really fucked up. But now I must say, also again, please, let me reiterate. This is a dream. And I know it sounds very racist, but I can't control what the fuck happens in my dreams. So here it goes.
Okay.
First, I don't know what happened, but I was hanging out in a big room. And there was a woman in there and a big chimpanzee. I swear, it was like a big chimpanzee that was going around. And a couple other people in the room were like all cool with the chimpanzee. And all I'm thinking is, these things fucking rip your balls off and bite your face and shit like that. And I didn't want to look at them
or show fear, but I was afraid. And the thing, like, sensed the fear in me and starts coming over and, like fucking with me.
Right.
And
who was the girl? She white girl or black girl?
It was a white girl.
Did you like her?
I didn't know her.
Okay.
Was she coming from school or was it summer vacation?
I have no idea what that. I'm not going to let you elaborate and make this worse than it comes off being a dream.
Okay, so the some people were cool with the chimpanzee, but you were afraid of it.
I didn't like the chimpanzee because I've seen, and this has nothing to do with anything else, but the fact that I know the chimpanzees are very vicious when they attack and things like that. So, but it was supposed to be cool, but I was kind of being, you know, very fearful of this chimpanzee. Then, I don't know how this turned around to something, but two guys were in the room, and they were blowing the chimpanzee.
Wait, two guys?
See, two guys are in the room blowing the chimpanzee.
How's that racist?
It wasn't me. Or, no, it gets...
Wait, who are the guys?
I don't know.
And what was the chimpanzee doing?
The chimpanzee was getting a blowjob and, I guess, enjoying it.
Was he a crack dealer?
And one of the guys was like... Because I was looking over like, what the fuck is going on? And the guy looked over and he's like talking about how you got to grab the chimpanzee's dick.
Oh, no.
And it was really bad. So what are you saying, oh no, for?
Keep going
go
with
ahead.
The dream.
No, go ahead. What do you have so far, Jimmy?
That the chimpanzee is your racist mind's putting a black man as a chimpanzee.
Really?
Yeah, but
why would I do that?
It's just because it's an irrational fear of black people that you have.
Okay.
And I think that's what it is. And yet other people in the room aren't afraid of him. So you see how we all interact with black guys and not afraid, but you have this irrational anger, which I think is fear-based.
Okay.
And but deep down, it's because you want to suck their big dicks.
No!
Oh my God, is that scary?
You just told my story.
See, that I know isn't the gist of this dream.
No, but the fear part, I believe. I'm kidding about that part.
Well, that could be. That could be the way I've interpreted it into a dream. I don't know where the blowing...
I actually wouldn't have went there, but you said it was racist, so I'm assuming it had something
well,
to do with
later
that.
On in the dream, like okay, that happened, and that was all weird and shit. And then, you know how dreams are. Then I'm in some department store. And for some
were you
reason,
Woolworths and Woolco?
Yes, I was in a department store. It had elevators and
hope it wasn't a Sears in Florida in 1981. All right, guys.
For just for you. Good. I was buying a department. Yes, I was in the department store, and there was an elevator, so I was on one of the top floors, and this woman, this older woman, was trying to get something from one of the shelves that she wanted to purchase, I gather. And she couldn't do it because something was in the way. And I could have helped her out, but I had to get this giant bowl from the top shelf and take that out because I had to get a bowl for some reason. So I grabbed the bowl and I just walked out. And she goes, "Can't help me, huh?" And I go, "I'm in a rush." And went to the elevators to get downstairs. So,
by the way, another gay thing, grabbing a ball.
No, bowl.
A big bowl, of course. Bowl. You had to reach up and grab a bowl. You were molested by somebody of color. You were forced to suck a dick of color.
In the treehouse.
No, you had to reach up and grab a bowl. It might have been a Mexican guy from the farm that you hung out on or whatever.
What does a bowl represent?
You're reaching up, grabbing a ball. It's a word thing. Dreams do that word shit.
So instead, I'm reaching up to a giant sack
ball
with balls in
them. Yes.
And
why can't you help me? That's probably what you were saying. Why? That's probably what your mind was going. Why can't you help me? No one was helping you.
No one was helping me.
Big dark dick in your young white mouth.
I do remember though. It was a white bowl, because it was a white porcelain.
Oh.
Big I have a soup bowl in my house that is very similar. One of the big white soup bowls, but it was bigger than that.
Okay.
It was like a big white bowl.
Except in your house, a statue's holding it like
this. Yes, of course.
On the fucking front yard. Okay,
So I bring...
What was the woman trying to get?
I don't know what she was trying to get, but it was something that was stuck on a shelf, and she was kind of backed in a corner, like she was stuck in there too, kind of, as she's trying to get this thing out. It was very awkward, and I could have helped her very easily get whatever she needed off the shelf, because it wasn't high up or anything. But instead, I inconvenienced her more by opening the door to leave that room that this merchandise was in.
She represents your mom, who didn't help you when you were young.
Or he didn't help. Always helped me.
Or he maybe
not when you were getting mouth raped.
No, I've never gotten mouth raped. Anthony, I assure you.
Anthony's thing is he's got arms and guns. Maybe you're afraid that you won't be able to protect a girl that you're with, and a girl is going to be injured or taken away from you.
She was an older woman. It was an old woman, and I looked at her like, get the fuck out. Like,
why can't you help me? Mean
like I don't want to help her with anything. So you're thinking it's me that needs the help instead of
I don't know.
No, this woman.
Then I thought it might be the girl. She's trapped in a corner trying to read something, and she's saying, why don't you help me?
Yeah.
So you're kind of just leaving her without help. You're leaving her without being helped. But if she was younger, I would say maybe it's a fear, but if she's an old lady, I don't know what that means.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, I go downstairs with the bowl in the elevator. Now, by the time I walk out of the department
store... Of course you go down. Yeah. Of course you go down.
I'm going down.
Of course.
Oh, shit.
Big ball in the elevator. You go down.
Oh,
I got it.
No.
Shaft. Elevator shaft.
Elevator shaft. I didn't even think of that.
What happened? Like the Shining fucking... But it was milk coming out in your face in the elevator? Did somebody have on a fucking dog or bunny rabbit outfit? You fucking mo. All right, guys.
So I go downstairs in this department store, but I don't pay for the bowl. But nobody, like, gives me a problem, but I can't even see cash registers or anything. And I leave, and I'm out now in the parking lot, and it's nighttime, right? And now instead of the bowl, for some reason, I have a pizza. and it's not in a box. It's just the pie.
Of course it's not, because that would be a vagina. Why would it be?
It's not in a box. The pizza is like under my arm, like you would hold a stack of books, like that. Like not flat either. Like it's under my arm, laying there, like where the cheese would all drip off. But it's not. There's a little grease dripping off of it, but And in the other hand, I think I might have the bowl or something. And I'm walking, and now I notice that I'm being flanked by two gentlemen of color. Okay. And they look a little gangsta. So, and then it hits me. I'm like, holy shit. These are the two guys that, like, threatened me if I didn't have, like, money for them or something tomorrow. They were going to fuck me up, you know? So I've got this dumb pizza in a bowl. I don't have a gun with me or anything. So the black guy comes up and like goes, you know, I'm gonna smack you in your fucking head. And then he bashes me in the head. And I was like, ow, that, you know, that fucking hurt and shit. And then he's like, where's my shit? And he was getting all fucking in my face and pissed off. And took the pizza, took the bowl.
Why would you want the pizza after it's been against your fucking shirt?
I don't
it
know.
Probably has your shirt cookies in it.
Shirt cookies.
It's been dripping half the pizza. It looks like your pizza had a stroke because this fucking cheese is all on one side.
Stroke pizza. And then it got really weird where he touched my leg.
Of course he did.
He touched my leg, and I started thinking, holy shit. This motherfucker is going to try something. So I got up and tried to run. And you know how running goes in dreams?
No.
It doesn't work.
Yeah.
So I'm like, ah. And then he like punched me in the head. And the other guy like grabbed me too and started like kicking my ass. And I woke up. But there was no,
that's racist, though.
There was no sexual. Well, the whole thing of it being going from the chimp to the that and then the gangsters. And the
chimp could just honestly represent aggressive males. Like, yeah. There are other people comfortable with them, and you're uncomfortable with certain aggressive males. That's why you got to protect yourself.
Yeah,
I think it's all about protection. And you're afraid that you'll be walking through a parking lot, and someone will try to rob you, and all you'll have is some motherfucking pizza in a bowl.
Pizza in a dumb bowl.
I don't know what the bowl means. Somebody might have
bowl might represent something. I don't know what it is, but...
Yeah, I would love to. Somebody out there might have an interesting interpretation of that, which we'll never know if it's real or not.
Now I realize how you guys cover like 20 hours of radio a week with a fucking 2-hour dumb dream story, and this guy who thinks he's a fucking doctor.
Well, that's what we do.
But
I'm
realizing I don't know what I'm. I
know,
recognize
you try
that
to
I
analyze
know.
These things.
What was your, I would like to analyze one of your dreams. What was it? There was an apple, and somebody fed it to me with their fucking palm flattened.
I don't even have big teeth anymore.
Well,
all right. No need to be literal.
But I always have dreams that I can't that no matter what happens, if I have a firearm and I need to use it, it never works.
Cops have that dream a lot,
never
too.
Never fucking works.
I Googled some dream meetings. Now, I know that, you know, there's only so much legitimacy that you could really put in. Because I'm sure, like, every site says something different for each
sure.
object. But this one says, if you see a bowl in your dream, it symbolizes the womb and sense of security. Consider the condition of the bowl and how it is treated or handled in the dream. This may offer clues as to how you feel you were being treated in a particular relationship.
All right. The bowl was very pristine. It was brand new, off the shelf.
Yeah.
Very, very white.
Maybe that's how you like, you know what? Maybe that's a thing about the way you look at women.
Oh, I like them pristine and nice
and white.
And white.
And white. And unbroken.
And smooth and unbroken and new.
And you're afraid.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that girl, that represents the woman.
That represents the girl.
And
I
you're
had to
afraid
take the girl.
She's going
to
be hurt by fucking people.
And I shunned the old lady.
Yes.
I took that because I shunned the old lady in exchange for the nice new white bowl.
Could be about your ex-marriage or your something with the mother of the
I
marriage.
I think it's just that I don't like old broads.
Nah, that means something.
I think you're an alcoholic.
All right. I don't have to dream to... that's when I pass out, when I fucking hallucinate.
But that makes perfect sense. That you're fucking carrying the bowl and the guys are going to hurt you and you're carrying this bowl.
Black guys, though.
Well, you're afraid of black guys.
It's always black guys in my dreams. Like, always, like, if there's a problem. Either that or it's like some kind of military thing going on. Like, some kind of thing happening. But again, the gun never works. They don't have the right bullets for the gun. It sucks. You shoot and it goes like, pfft, nothing happens. Oh.
You want some more
Help
symbols
me out.
Out of your dream?
Help me out.
It says here that to see or eat pizza in your dream represents abundance, choices, and variety. It may also indicate that you are lacking or feeling deprived of something. Alternatively, a pizza may have similar significance to a circle.
Hmm.
A bowl is circular.
Bowl.
And so is pizza.
Pizza. Pizza.
You want to do the chimp? To see a bowl. Chimpanzee in your dream suggests that what you thought was true is actually not. You are overthinking an issue.
I don't know about that. I believe that's more aggression.
How do they pull that out of their ass?
No, I don't believe that.
And who comes up with these? You know, that's just anybody's opinion.
Yes.
Oh, you see a chimp in your dream. That means want to go to a double feature.
Yeah, it means...
That's how old you are.
I know.
That you improv double feature.
When was the last time there was a double feature?
That's what a dream means, that you want to go see a talkie.
A double feature.
You want to go to the drive-in.
Oh, it's great. We see cartoons first. Then there's a newsreel.
A double feature. Who decides what it means?
Yeah, a chimp shouldn't mean like that. It shouldn't be so abstract. Dreams, that's why I don't like how abstract they are, because then they can be interpreted into anything.
Yeah.
How about I just was fucking like my synapses in my head were just clicking together things that don't make fucking sense, and that happens.
I live that all the time.
Yeah, well, in a waking state.
Yes.
I have a lot of these weird dreams that just sometimes they're in the same location. Like, there's a house that I've been to in 1,000 dreams, and the same thing happens in the house, same little passageways and stuff. It's just really weird. We have an armchair psychologist, Rick, in Austin, Texas. Rick, how are you?
What's up?
You have absolutely no experience in this, right?
None whatsoever.
All right. Hold on for 2 seconds because we have a doctor on the phone. That's what I want to get to. All right. Yes, Dr. Chipperson.
Wait, if the guy's an armchair psychologist, does that mean that he helps armchairs that are feeling blue or something? I don't know. Wait. No, maybe the armchair doesn't know what he's like. What he's sitting on.
Chip, enough about the armchair. I want to know about my dream with the bowl, the pizza.
He's probably afraid of something, that if you had a bowl of pizza, that you wouldn't have nowhere to carry it or something, you know? Or maybe he was afraid that your ball would fall down or something. Like, he was on a shelf and there's the ball and you're like, hey, where's the ball? Everybody's like, go bowling for dollars. I don't know.
What about the chimpanzee?
What's that?
What about the chimpanzee in my dream? I had
You're probably afraid that your pan is going to have a bunch of ansy in it or something.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. He did not. He did not even.
You probably was getting like a pan of ansy or something. I don't, you know, like,
Where did you go to medical school, by the way, Dr. Chipperson?
What's that?
Yeah, where did you go to medical
school? I heard you. I went to Jerry Hopkins.
Jerry Hopkins.
That means something, that you was in a store or something.
Oh, right, yeah, because I was in a department store, yeah.
And maybe the ball symbolizes the one that your father threw against the wall because of the spaghetti incident. And you was mad because your mother was going, why don't you help me? So maybe you was really scared that you couldn't help your mother when your father was throwing a ball up against the thing, and the pizza kind of represents the same kind of food.
Well, that is very intuitive of Chip. I didn't think you could actually.
Yeah, I went. I wanted to go to tour them, but I couldn't get in, so I was out of tour them.
Right. I'm trying to think if there was one more thing in the dream. Oh, the black guys. What does that represent?
Black eyes. Yeah, black eyes. You're probably afraid of being beaten up. You're getting black eyes.
No, it was
hitting you.
It wasn't eyes. It was two black gentlemen.
No, I know, but sometimes the dreams work. Like, I used to dream that sometimes I would see black guys, too, and they'd be on top of my mother, and they'd be giving it to her, and she'd be yelling, fuck me, and she'd be yelling, stick that black dick farther in, and I'd be in the bushes, and I'd be watching through the bushes or something, and I'd be crying, but then I would notice that there was a whole big puddle in front of my pants.
And what do you think that represented?
That my mother fucked black guys and I came in my pants.
So there's no real abstract thought going on there.
What's that?
You heard me.
No, I didn't. I don't know what abstract means.
Oh, I didn't think so.
Oh, it's kind of like being distracted, but your abs. That's what you're. That's what your abs are distracted. Abstract.
It's a laugh. It's retarded. No, I was trying to say, like your dream doesn't necessarily have to mean exactly what it means, that your mother is fucking black guys and you came in your pants.
Oh, I thought you were talking about, I thought it was a memory.
Oh, no, it was a dream when you're sleeping, we're talking about.
She says, Chip, go outside because Lamar got to help me fix something. And then you look through the window and his back is all sweaty and the back of his dark chocolatey butt cheeks are all sweaty and she's digging her fingernails in and he's doing it so hard that the lamp falls off the end table and you know your father bought it out or something. And he don't pull out and he just leaves it in there and he punches in the face. That's what I think.
That's what you think. Well, wow, Dr. Chipperson, you've been very informative.
Thanks. Thanks.
And say hi to your mom.
I'm going to be a couch psychologist with the armchair one.
But you talk to couches.
Yeah, I know. That's what I said.
thank you, Dr. Chipperson.
Okay. I did great then. I was terrible to crack it up.
Hang the phone
up. That was really funny. Fucking, they probably should have me as a regular or something.
God damn, Dr. Chipperson was, Jimmy, you missed Dr. Chipperson when you went to the bathroom. Yeah, he's really good. He's very insightful with dreams. Yeah, he had a really good one about his mom. I'll tell you about it sometime. Boy, you think the bowl represents the bowl of spaghetti that hit the wall, and then the pizza is like Italian food, and the old woman saying "Help me" is my mom, and the only thing I could think of as helping is taking the bowl away.
What? According to that website, the bowl was the womb. Like, it's a motherly thing. Oh, so there's definitely some kind of mom thing going on.
Yeah, maybe you were scared that your father was going to hurt your mother and that you couldn't help your mother.
Oh.
And you would see him yelling and screaming at her, and you were just like a little fucking little skinny waif-bodied fruit hiding behind the fucking whatever.
So if I ever have a dream that my girlfriend's pregnant, I just take a bowl and throw it down the stairs? Will that represent
no.
a good egg?
No, what you do is you fucking scrape the bowl out.
Scrape it clean. Yeah. Put it in the scalding hot dishwasher.
You take a Hoover and you clean the inside of the bowl. Pour Drano in it.
Get every piece of tomato.
Yeah, then you bury the bowl in a ditch.
Little fella.
Poor little bowl.
Poor little bowl.
Wasn't bigger than a squirrel.
Oh, that's fucked up, man.
Yeah, maybe it means something like that.
Yeah. God damn. We haven't taken a break or anything, have we?
We've taken one.
One?
One
break.
That's
cray cray, yo. That's off the hizook.
I'll tell you what.
Right, Rich?
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
When I'm working Buffalo June 17th, I won't be taking a break. When I'm at...
oh, boy.
So happy.
What's the name of the place? Don't help him.
At Nitsy's. Music Hall.
Wait. What's the name of the place?
I like to spell my name so the listeners don't screw it up.
It's now, how do they, what's the word if you spell something the way it sounds instead of the actual spelling?
What's
maybe
the word?
We could spell it that way.
Oh.
You know, like, instead of spelling something the way it's actually spelled.
Like, instead of spelling...
like psychiatrist.
Yeah.
You would spell it...
With a P.
S, right. You wouldn't spell it P-H.
Oh, you spell it...
You'd spell it S... Y
psychiatrist
K, yeah. You know, something like that. So you, and what is that called? Writing something.
Phonetically.
Very good, very good.
Fuck, did I get that right? You know so why? Because when I had my bar mitzvah, I was so fucked
your
up.
Bar mitzvah.
My bar mitzvah. I said,
oh, okay.
I was so fucked up in Hebrew school. I just always fucked off in Hebrew school.
Wow, and you're a rebel.
I was crazy.
What, did you fucking spin yarmulkes on your fingers?
Whoa, look at
that's
that.
Crazy.
He's going for the long tongs.
Right, how many times are you going to go for the long time?
What does that even mean?
I keep saying I love the commercial. I keep saying you don't even know it. So I did phonetically because I didn't know in Hebrew. I couldn't read Hebrew. I was a fuck up.
And then I did so mine.
And
did it
they
in
wrote it out
English.
American, the rabbi who was off the hook.
In American. That's very good. They wrote
English.
It in American, right?
In English. And I did my fucking bar mitzvah. I didn't make any mistakes.
Well, shouldn't you not like be bar mitzvahed if you can't read from the Torah in its native Hebrew hieroglyphics, whatever the fuck that is?
I got this part right.
It's a good visual
for the radio.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. Anyhow, June 17th. Did you see?
Oh boy!
Did you guys see fucking The Apprentice last night?
Nope.
No,
I know Sam John saw it.
Well, at the end, towards the end, John Rich and Marlene, whatever her name is.
Wait, who?
Marlene, yeah.
Marley Matlin, whatever her name is.
Uh-huh, Marlene Matlin.
Marley. Bob. They sang together.
Oh, really?
And then, she was doing this.
She was doing this, and let me just note. What was she making? Fucking Vienna sausages?
Yeah,
those little fingers started
unbendable
twitching.
Stiff fingers. Little and, gargoyle hands.
But she was signing as she was singing. But
yeah.
Her signing was very pitchy.
Oh my God. We didn't go to break for that.
I bet you those two singing sound like Putting on the Ritz and Young Frankenstein.
Putting on the Ritz!
Because she's deaf. she's as deaf as they come.
A mite bit deaf.
Oh, well, she has a good girl ear and a naughty girl ear.
Imava.
Oh, imava good boy phone and im naughty boy phone.
And im naughty. All right, well, do you need to plug anything, James?
Just June 15th at the Comedy Festival.
Yes.
I will be with Jim Brewer, Dave Attell, and Bill Burr. We're performing opening night at the festival, June 15th in Chicago.
It's magical.
It's a good show.
It's magical.
That's all I have.
All right, we'll be right back.
Why do you have two phones?
You know...
Okay, shit.
What?
I forgot about that one. Patrice and me doing the deaf version of Queen. Yeah.
Maybe this is why I don't get certain guests on my Boneyard show.
Uh-oh, what's the matter?
We have Brian Johnson coming in, and I want to do him on the Boneyard show as well. So I
Brian
asked,
Johnson of AC/DC fame?
Yes.
Yes.
He's promoting his book. And so I ask for it, because I don't ask for me.
Well, you asked for it.
And I get a response. I get all these email chains, and here's the response I get from Laura, his manager or whatever. Wait. Uh-oh. Laura Haywood. She's the senior manager, talent relations, Sirius XM Radio.
Oh.
Hi, Ted. Because my fucking my email is not a fucking Jim Norton one. It says Ted. It's not what you think it is, but it's Ted something.
Yeah, yeah.
No, it's not. It's not. I'm saying it's not Ted Check. I'm not trying to be.
Yeah.
She writes, "I believe Brian's schedule is totally locked, but I will double check with him when I'm back on Monday." So, I don't know who Lori is. I've never met her, but whoever is the senior manager of talent relations thinks that Ted was asking. Like, that's the communication.
That's how much people pay attention to what's going on.
And I don't mean that she should recognize my email, but whoever's asking for me might want to say the guy's name is Jim Norton. Like, when I send an email to people and I say I'd like to try to get Brian Johnson on my Boneyard show and they forward it to her, they might want to say this is Jim Norton.
Yeah.
He has a Boneyard show. Hi, Ted!
Do you have to keep banging on the table?
Yes, I do, because it's fucking irritating.
He's angry. That's what he does when he's angry. Unfucking believable. What's that?
That's her. I don't know if you know her by face.
I'm not faulting her, because she's not supposed to just recognize my email address.
Wow, she's good looking.
Your argument just went down the shitter, Jimmy.
What?
Because she's kind of attractive.
She's very attractive.
I didn't say she was ugly.
I know, but your argument about anything. I say she's right. Wow.
So, hi, Ted!
Diet
wow,
Coke.
She's very
hi, Ted.
That's the kind of girl that
let me see.
No
did he,
me.
Yeah. I'm looking through all the email. Whatever.
Is it going to work out, you think, in the end?
No, it's not going to work out in the end because his schedule's locked.
Where's my soup?
Because why would the talent coordinator of SiriusXM, whoever she is, get that for Ted? He doesn't exist.
Yeah.
Wish guess.
For Brian Johnson for the Boneyard Show.
You're fucked.
Oh, shit.
Why am I fucked?
He's locked.
He's locked?
Locked?
But he's doing O&A.
But it's Jimmy Norton.
Yeah, I know he's doing O&A, but that's not my fucking...
Because I locked it in. What's up?
But I mean, I'm saying, why can't I get him on the other show, which is a music show I do?
Yeah. Because she handles books.
She handles books for SiriusXM?
Mm-hmm.
Why? I don't know her at all.
Is she married?
What?
But she should have the Boneyard thing. Like, she should know that the Boneyard...
Ugh, too many fucking people involved. It's...
Too many hands in the soup.
I want one person to fucking... It's so fucking enraging.
Why can't you just deal directly with them? With, like...
Because I don't give a fuck about the, and I know that's me being selfish, but I don't care about their schedules and other channels.
Right.
I don't care.
It's like, this is what you want, and you shouldn't care. It's like, this is what I want.
Hi, Ted!
Ooh, that is a bad one. Imagine calling everybody you know based on their email address, like the first thing in the address.
Okay.
What?
So I sent the email.
Hey, slobbering shoe bag.
All right, thank you.
Yeah.
I would love to get Brian Johnson on my show. I forward that. Got it.
Thanks,
looping in the team here.
Mm.
So the team got looped in that Ted.
That was looping in the team. It was the corporate speak for I told everybody.
Well, that's good, though. That's good.
Hey, you might get him.
Doubtful. Just disgusted. Why do I give a fuck?
Because you're Jimmy Norton, professional. I'm sure someone will have a talking to.
No, but it's like, if he's doing music channels...
Yeah.
Why can't I get him on that? And maybe he's talking to somebody who he knows from the Boneyard. Okay, that's fine, but why can't he be on two shows? It doesn't.
Yeah, and that would seem to be one of the more conducive music channels. Yeah. You could talk to him.
Hi, Ted!
Ted, they're gonna be looking for Ted, and they ain't gonna find him. He's not gonna clamor about how he wants to see have him as a guest.
Why would she try to help me? She has no idea who I am.
No.
You're fucking great at this. You just feed it.
But he's right. He's right. He's not feeding me. I know he's right. He's 100% right.
It's ridiculous that somebody should they should know who you are, what channel you're on.
Or she should be told. Nobody told her.
No.
They just forwarded her to the email. Hey, Ted wants to talk to him.
Oh, Jesus. That is bad.
That's the problem with everybody email loops and all this fucking shit that corporate. Nobody just calls anybody. Hey, Jim has a show. He'd like to talk to him. Hold on. Let me check.
The second you loop in the team, by the way, you are instantly you're absolved of any responsibility because the team is now looped in.
Ugh, so
because now you
annoying.
Could say, I don't know, we handed it off to this division or people's. Or it's never one person you can go to anymore, and that's in any industry. And just be like, can I talk to the guy that decided to do this? And it's like, well, it was sort of a consortium of the department itself, and we also brought in some consulting for, oh, so who is it? Well, there's not any one person. It's an entity. You're dealing with an entity.
I don't know who that woman is. And again, I know she works here, and I'm sure she does her job well. I just don't know her.
I don't know what she does.
That's how locked in we are with people. I don't know who this person is, so I can't go to her and ask her, because I never heard of her.
No.
And she's obviously never heard of me.
Ted, I guess, through email.
She sent a friendly response.
Oh.
Why should she give him to Ted? Who the fuck is Ted?
Maybe Ted could do the interview. Since he's getting the emails.
Why are there two C's and only one A and one D? Go. Did you ever think of singing hex bells to make the language less salty? Does it bother you that your name is also called a penis? Do you hear the people ever call you Brian Penis or Brian Dick or Brian Boner? Go. Sorry, I just read that.
No,
fucking livid.
I would be too. I sometimes get a little up in arms about the guesting on this very program.
How do you mean?
Well, sometimes I go like, I didn't want that guy. And then
I'm trying.
And then the guy, yeah, I know. Well, you know, you somehow got in again under the wire. Yeah, you know. Sometimes you get a guest and then go, oh, I didn't want that guest. And then you realize, why am I talking to this guy?
Thank God we have fucking... I will say this. I'm so happy I don't have to rely on fucking 50 people for this show.
Yes.
Really. If I didn't push and fucking and complain, I would get nobody on that fucking show.
Yeah.
Nobody.
Yeah. You got to get in there.
And I know I should. I don't. This is one thing I hate about working for, like, with this 50 stations. The only one of the very few disadvantages is I know I should. I know that there's other people to be considered besides me. I don't give a fuck. You're paying me to do a show. I want to fucking get these guys on. And it's like, why wouldn't I want to interview Brian Johnson for my show? I'm on 5 nights a week. Why wouldn't I want to?
You should be on their mind whenever they have a musical guest. You should be one of the guys that go, okay, here's the list of stations. Jimmy's show, or Ted, whatever it is, his show.
Hi, Ted! Hello, madam! How are you? I'm a fictional character!
Holy shit.
I don't exist!
Yes, he's fake. It was cordial, though.
Again, I'm not even shitting on her. There's no way she could know that.
Right.
Because nobody told her.
No one told
her. She's not a, you know, again, but the odd part is I don't know her at all.
Mm-hmm.
That's the relation we have. I don't know this person.
Yeah. Someone needs a talking to. I don't know who, but someone needs to be talked to. There's nothing worse than just utter disgust, because there's nothing you can do about it. You just have to, like, just take it. Isn't it great? Wow. Well, we do have Sam Robertson here, who is our resident expert on wrestling. And what a huge story that came out over the weekend. Wow. One of the biggies.
Oh, yeah.
Gone.
Yeah.
One of the biggies gone. Macho Man. Randy Macho Man Savage.
Maybe the biggest.
Would you put him as... Well, I would put Hulk Hogan as the biggest.
Sure.
As far as, you know, history goes, longevity. Mm-hmm. Well, now, of course, longevity, you know, because he's still alive.
You beat him out.
But I mean, career longevity. And, yeah, you'd have to put the Hulkster. Second, would you put Macho Man, Randy Savage, or Rowdy Roddy Piper?
How about The Rock? Maybe not longevity, but it's, or Andre the Giant. Those are more famous guys.
Baystar Calhoun.
All right, there you go. 23 Skidoo again.
But Andre the Giant, I think, was more famous than any of them, no?
Yeah, but in terms of impact, Hulk Hogan had the biggest impact. And then The Rock had a bigger impact than Macho Man, sure. But it was a different era.
Yeah, yeah. I think I'm just talking wrestling, like, overall, not just a part of,
yeah.
of like, I don't know.
Because you'd have...
And The Rock, you know, because of acting, you kind of, in hindsight, look at him as...
He had 4 or 5 years.
Pretty
that's
huge,
it.
Yeah.
The Undertaker is another one.
Yeah, but
since 1990, he's been around, and now it's
2011. Yeah, but he's not, you know, snapping to a Slim Jim and.
No.
Which one did I meet? Like, the guy with the mask?
Oh yeah.
Which guy with the
Some
mask?
Some monster.
Abyss.
Yeah.
Guy with the mask. He's a monster.
Yeah. How about Goldberg?
Goldberg is not
Flash. Yeah, Flash in the pan.
How about the other one?
There are lots of other ones.
Yeah, the other one.
There are many other ones.
Yeah.
The other guy.
The Brooklyn Brawler.
Classy Freddy Blassie, you horse's assy.
The guy, there's a guy who's editing with Bonnie, helping Bonnie edit, and he made a documentary on wrestling. Him, I don't know the name, but he followed like 4 or 5 wrestlers.
For the last 6 years.
Have you seen
wrestler.
This?
Well, was it a big documentary?
Wrestlers.
One of the wrestlers died.
Wow, that's
he overdosed or something. He was in jail. I'll get you the documentary. You'll
Please
love
do.
It. No, for you because you're a wrestling kid.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
You know,
wrestling.
But
kid.
I think Macho Man was probably behind Hulk Hogan, the biggest. I mean, there aren't many other wrestlers who would have garnered the attention that he did. It was on every single news channel on Friday.
It really was, yeah.
And they've never done that.
All right, yeah. Think about if another wrestler died, if it would just be like as big a story as it was. I think that's pretty big.
Yeah, I think Macho Man probably the second biggest.
What about Bruno Sammartino?
I don't think he's don't as big as a Macho Man.
No.
Back in the day, he was. See, it's all relative.
What if Ultimate Warrior died? You think he'd get the coverage like the Macho Man?
No, I don't think he would.
Warrior.
And I think that also has a lot to do with the fact that his legacy was somewhat tarnished towards the end.
Somewhat.
Yes.
Who?
The Ultimate Warrior.
What happened?
Warrior. Just.
Warrior.
Well, he's just crazy.
Yeah, and
he's batshit crazy.
What about the guy that pissed himself in here?
Ah,
the Iron Sheik.
Iron Sheik, come a clutch. I humble you. I fuck you in the ass, and I humble you.
He became a bit of a parody towards...
Yeah, that's
what,
true.
His legacy would be that he became a bit of a parody towards...
Curly-shoed joke.
But for me, when I was a kid, Macho Man was way more
Macho
important
Man
than
was
Hulk
very
Hogan.
Flamboyant, could rock the mic.
Better than anyone.
Yeah, yeah, one of the best. We were up in... when we were up in the Poconos the other day, we went to a convenience store, beer store.
Yeah, beer.
And it was very convenient. They had beer. and there was a tin, a round tin with, you know, Slim Jims in there.
Yeah.
And it was the outside painted. So his picture was on it. And he's like, whoa. And I'm like, Macho Man, Randy Savage picture. And I was like telling the guy behind the counter, I go, yeah. Collector's item right here.
Yeah.
They tried
to have other wrestlers do the Slim Jim commercials, too.
None
of them worked the way Macho Man did. The Warrior just, did Slim Jim
Slim Jim. The
right.
Warrior did?
Yeah.
Do you have that on YouTube or something like that?
All of the... maybe we could talk to Troy, because all the conspiracy theorists...
Oh, no.
...are theorizing that perhaps Macho Man was responsible for making sure that the Rapture didn't happen.
Yeah, I heard tell that. Now, some people think Macho Man had a heart attack.
I actually have a picture of him saving the day. It's right here, as a matter of fact. See, what happened was Macho Man came off the top rope in heaven and gave the flying elbow to Jesus, who was about to fuck the world up.
Just ready to get that rapture thing going. And Macho Man gave the flying elbow to that's, Jesus.
That's not real. Somebody added that.
And just stopped the rapture from happening.
I've got an
wow,
an Ultimate Warrior Slim Jim commercial and a Bam Bam Bigelow.
Bam Bam Bigelow.
Who the fuck?
Asbury Park, New Jersey's finest. Yeah.
Wow. All right. Let's see. Well, that's here's the curse of the Slim Jim commercial.
Here's Warrior.
Here's Warrior.
Oh shit! Sorry.
Come on, Dan.
What do you want to do?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
You boys a bit bored? Step into it. Step into a Slim Jim. Think we just ain't playing? Hey, guys. Antique. Step into it! Need a little excitement! Step into a Slim Jim!
Not as good.
No, he's really over the top, I'd say, on it.
You want to see Bam Bam Bigelow?
Let's see Bam Bam Bigelow's. One's for Wimps and Punks! Oh, the potato chip.
And the other's for me.
What's that?
You need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim!
No.
Nah, that stinks.
Bam Bam didn't
that
have it.
That sucks. And where's the original? The Macho Man, Randy Savage.
There's a lot of parody. That's why it's hard to get through.
A lot of parody is turning up lately. A lot of people really taking his death seriously.
Taking it
to heart. Oops.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
Now, that's a Slim Jim commercial. What happened?
Well, something happened.
I'll tell you this, that commercial.
Awful. He was fucking
talking about. That's not.
I'm gonna throw the other guy through the ropes.
He wasn't awful.
Stunk. What's gonna happen to me when the Macho Man? I'm the Macho Man. I'm macho.
Randy Savage, there is a lot of history between you and Jake the Snake Roberts.
If all you women out there forced to watch your man or your husband laid out unconscious with some other injury, that might make you a little bit upset. That might make you a little bit over the edge. That might make you a little bit insane, if you know what I mean. And a few men out there were forced to watch your wife or your woman, or your main squeeze, begging to another man, and then getting slapped by another man.
What?
That might make
Jake Roberts. Jake the Snake.
That might make you a little bit over
Macho
the
Man's
edge.
Talking about Jake.
That might make you a little bit insane. But not me, Snake Man. Not me. Because I know what I'm going to do to you tonight!
What are you doing?
Maybe I am insane. Maybe I am insane. And maybe it's time for you, Jake the Snake Roberts, to find out how insane I am.
Who's that, Lewis Black?
Right now,
Let's get back to ringside.
Are
you going to want to go toe-to-toe with that guy?
No. That was a great loss over the weekend. What a great loss.
I had the sunglasses, I had the bandana, I had the t-shirt, I had everything.
You did.
The wristbands.
Did your mommy get them for you, or did she make them?
No,
did she
sweet.
Fucking weave the bandana herself?
She bought the real ones.
Yeah.
You can still wear the wristband, now you have to put bark on it. And windshield glass.
Snap into a Slim Jim.
That was fucking horrible, that commercial.
Yeah. Well, so they're saying he had a heart attack.
Yeah, they said he had a heart attack while he was driving.
Well, that's what his brother is saying, because I think the autopsy...
Leaping Lanny Poffo?
Yeah, the autopsy report said, like, inconclusive or something.
Said no
like that.
Heart attack yet? Well, he might have been on those steroids, huh?
Well, I mean, steroids don't make... He could have been, but why jump to conclusions?
Why jump to conclusions?
By the way, 38 days on the wrestler death clock.
Oh, wrestler death clock was reset. Who was the last wrestler to go?
Sweet and Sour Larry Sweeney.
Sweet and Sour Larry Sweeney went 38 days ago. A mere 38 days ago.
How'd he die? He hung himself at a wrestling school.
Did you know him or no?
Yeah, I did. I worked a show with him.
Oh, shit.
He was 29.
Get out of here.
29?
Larry Sweeney was, yeah.
And he's still in school?
It's in a wrestling skull. Why did he, what, anybody have any comments on why he would have done that at such a young age?
He had some problems. He had severe bipolar and a whole bunch of stuff that made him lose a couple wrestling
So why
did
he just bring it back? Why would he keep buying it?
Oh, Chip. No, it's two.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage, was 58.
58 years young.
Exactly double his the other guy's age.
Oh, my God.
Which is
like a Kennedy Lincoln thing.
58's old for a wrestler.
That's fucking 90 for a wrestler.
That is true.
Why was he still wrestling?
No,
it's just most wrestlers don't make it to 58.
No.
Not wrestling, but they live.
Incorrect.
It's just...
That's not what I'm saying.
Did you see any accident pictures?
Yes. I saw a picture of the car smashed up on the tree.
Yeah, did it? Because I haven't seen it, but I heard it looks like he just drove smack into a tree.
Yeah, he just drove through a divider into oncoming traffic, past it, into a tree.
Think it was suicide?
No, because his wife was in the car.
Maybe they were arguing.
Oh, his wife is in the car, too.
His wife was minor injuries. Not Miss Elizabeth, by the way, because my mom called me and said Miss Elizabeth was in the car with him.
No, how would that be? Yes.
I informed my mom Miss Elizabeth had died several years ago.
She's dead.
Yeah, Miss Elizabeth is dead.
What'd she die of?
Like pills and alcohol.
She a wrestler, too?
She was a manager.
Oh.
She was the first lady of wrestling.
One of the bimbos that come out.
I remember the name. Was she from the 80s?
One of those bimbos that come out with the wrestlers, you know?
She was Macho's wife in real life.
Mm. Oh, really?
For a time.
Now
she's hanging out with Lex Luger and partying, and she died.
Now though, reunited in heaven.
Well, I don't know because Sensational Sherry, who managed the Macho King, also dead. So we'll see.
Wow, there's a friggin' brawl going on up there.
Yeah,
maybe they'll have some kind of a match in heaven to win the fancy of the Macho Man.
And you know, at one point, Macho Man teamed with Mr. Perfect, who is also dead.
Holy shit. Wrestling is an amazing activity.
As a tag team, you're never going to see again. Perfect Maniacs.
Yeah.
Gone
Perfect
forever. Maniacs.
I was part of a gang called the Maniacs.
Were you?
Why are you, Chip? What did you do?
Fuck everything.
Oh, yeah? Was it drugs? Was it vandalism? No. Was it stealing?
No, at least it's like selling candy we stole.
Oh, you stole candy?
Yeah.
It's not maniacal.
That's tough.
Fuck, I ran out of store, though. Boom.
Boom. Guess I shouldn't have taken that opportunity to put that spoonful of soup in my mouth.
You listen to more Macho Man promos.
Yeah.
A little bit later on, against Ming, the face of terror from the Dungeon of Doom, that means that Luger and the Macho Man, Randy Savage, will indeed be meeting here at Halloween Havoc.
How did anyone take that seriously?
Match. One down, one to go.
Ugh.
You know what? I beat the Zodiac, and we had even a little audience participation, because I'm wild, And I'm going to tell you something, Hulk Hogan.
Thanks.
What you said about me a few days ago, And I don't think you can separate business from friendship. I'm your friend. But if I ever see you in the ring, I can beat you. Don't you know? Yeah.
Randy Savage,
your mustache is crooked.
Your beard is hanging sideways, too, but I don't want to get into that. I'm not going to take personal pot shots at you or anybody else. That's not my nature.
Get in line, everybody.
I'm a little better guy than that. I don't mind telling you.
Cool.
I'm a bigger man.
Cool.
Well, how did we get into this?
That's okay, man.
Very curious.
I'm going to take Lex Luger because I know he's going to beat Ming because I'm going to make sure he does.
Can we just get away from the subject of the Luger? Potential Randy Savage match. I want to ask you one other question because everywhere I go, people are talking about these two monster trucks that are going to be colliding here a little bit later on.
Oh, no.
The Giant in the Dungeon of Doom truck and your good friend Hulk Hogan in the Hulkster's monster truck.
My curiosity is killing me just like a cat would be killed by the curiosity. Yeah, because of the fact machine versus machine and man versus man doubled and tripled by the exposure of the WCW Heavyweight Championship belt. Don't you think I have a little bit of interest right there? Friendships, business is business. Hulk Hogan already drew the line in the sand. I'm just following.
In the
sand. All right, we're going to be watching very closely.
I'm going to be a participant, and I'm going to be watching too through the video scope.
Thank you, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. He is one of a kind. Let's get you back inside.
Certainly is one of a kind.
You know, Ray's just suggested.
I've got a man.
Just suggested in my little headphones here.
Yeah.
I mean, we're talking about how I'm coping with the loss of the Macho Man.
True.
But, I mean, the only thing that would make me feel better is to hear a real fan of wrestling doing his best Macho Man impression. Somebody like a sex bagel, I guess.
Maybe E-Rock,
if he could do that.
Now, he does an impression.
He does a Macho Man impression.
Of the Macho Man.
Does he?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, please.
Hopefully from a few days ago.
Yeah, Jim, you should really be nicer to your fellow co-star. You should be mourning the loss of your co-star.
What?
Because you two guys were in the same film together.
Oh, that's true.
He was in Spider-Man.
He was in Spider-Man.
Bonesaw.
Oh, was he?
Oh, I didn't know.
Yes.
That.
Wow.
And after we deal with this tragic situation, somebody owes an apology.
Oh, boy.
Oh, shite. Oh.
So let's get E-Rock.
Oh, boy.
Somebody jumped the gun.
Ah,
now, I know what's going on here. But I thought that you knew that already. This will make sense in like 10
very
minutes.
Very curious. Very curious indeed.
Did he fight Hulk Hogan ever?
Of course he fought Hulk Hogan. Yeah, and Mega Powers Collide.
Where is the sex bagel? Why isn't the sex bagel on his way?
Well, I don't know that. I don't know the
where
answer.
Where is it?
Let's get the sex man to come in here.
Oh, here he comes.
Ugh.
I can't wait.
Awful.
I can't wait to hear
him. Fingers.
That's always my favorite part.
Snap into a fat Eric.
Oh.
See?
By the way, Eric, I hope he's training for Friday.
That's on this Friday?
Physical fitness challenge.
Physical fitness challenge. The money is still up.
Oh, yes.
I have $200 on Sam Roberts.
Jim has $50 on Eric.
Yeah.
To do
Eric.
What?
Physical fitness challenge.
Stop getting excited because you hear gambling.
Yeah. True. Our own E-Rock.
Hello.
Were
Hello,
you sad
Mr.
about
Eric.
Macho Man?
Yes.
He was your favorite?
He was one of my favorites.
He was my favorite.
I used to have the, back in the day,
the Pillow Buddy thing?
Yes.
Yep.
Totally. I used to have the WWF... wrestling buddies. They were made out of like a pillow material.
Ew.
So I had the Randy Savage one that you could jump off the couch and beat up and pin and
or cuddle with and hug when you're going to sleep.
Drill a hole in and fuck.
Yeah, you had a doll.
Yeah, or get chocolate on.
Try to tell your dad it was a puppet.
his fingers had chocolate on him. So he'd get it on the Macho Man.
The Macho Man was just stained with a garlic butter saw
and caramel all over.
Oh, shit.
Just treats.
Whipped cream.
Aw, young E-Rock wanting to cuddle with his Macho Man buddy.
But he wouldn't give up his dessert.
But he needed his treats.
E-Rock had the little chocolate in the corners of his mouth kissing the Macho Man.
Any of this happen, E-Rock?
No, not
all
food.
Right. Just wanted to get the facts out there.
No.
Now, we hear tell through our own Sam Roberts that somebody in this room does an amazing Macho Man Randy Savage impression.
It is not I, but I am willing to try.
Well, what do you mean it is not?
Well, actually, it's not him because he's not in character. I mean, I'd spoken to our producer, and he said if you wanted an intro with the music and the whole thing, that he could leave.
If we want to do this right, like Eric can leave, and I can do
the
Macho Man music.
We need the music, and then
Macho
he gets
Man
the
music,
mic.
You know what?
And then does an impression. Oh, shit! He just threw the mic down. He went to pick the mic stand up. It came apart. In two pieces, and then instead of putting it back, he threw the mic.
Well, because he wanted to slam down the whole mic stand, but when he pulled it, it came in half, so it lost the effect.
Yeah. Oh, my God. It's like Jerry Lundegaard with the ice scraper. is E-Rock going to participate in this? Or
I owe an apology.
Oh, yeah.
Let's get E-Rock. We have to get the music.
Where's the music? Here it is.
Here he comes.
And here comes... Oh, my God, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, coming in. What a spectacle this is. Macho Man.
Ooh, yeah. Funky like a monkey, too sweet to be sour, yeah.
Wow, fantastic. What an entrance. What do you plan on doing this evening?
Tell you, Hogan, that when I get my hands on you, it'll be the end. Of Hulkamania. As we know it! Oh, yeah! Dig it!
Holy smokes.
I like that impression because I'll tell you why, because Eric gets the dynamics.
The low
of the Macho Man. Because I would have just started screaming Macho Man shit.
No.
But Eric knew that sometimes the Macho Man gets real down and talks to you from his soul. But then he gets really angry.
Yeah, some of Friday I got my money on Sam because he's out of breath from that.
Oh, I know. He's huffing and puffing from doing an impression. Wow, that, you know, I wanted to goof on you, but you did. You had the dynamic down.
I told you he did it.
I couldn't even. I was humiliated.
That was the first time I was tried it.
So. What a haunting tribute to the man, the myth, the late Macho Man Randy Savage.
Very sad.
Very, very sad indeed. Are you going to go out back and bury your little Macho Man buddy?
No, that's long gone.
Poor little feller.
I wish I still had it.
Really?
Don't have it anymore.
Who likes wrestling more, you or him?
I do.
I like it a lot, but he's way into it. Like, it's scary how well he's into it.
See, Sam likes it from the viewpoint of somebody that knows a lot about it. The people, the dynamic, the business end of it. And Eric knows it like a five-year-old that just
likes
the colors.
Because he has no friends.
Eric still gets upset when the good guys lose.
come on.
Does he like John Cena?
He loves John Cena.
John Cena's the man.
John Cena.
Would he want a John Cena doll, do you think?
Oh, he has them. He's gotten John Cena to sign them for him.
Wow.
Definitely.
Damn.
And I remember when we went to the WrestleMania press conference last time, he was the one guy in the press who was wearing a Triple H t-shirt. While we interviewed Triple H, Eric was wearing a Triple H t-shirt.
That was the size.
Triple H.
Do you think that, because he was getting all those things signed, remember for the Katrina raffle?
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you still have all those things?
No,
the autograph,
but Katrina stuff is all gone.
Oh, okay.
We made a lot of money off that.
You did?
Yeah. Nah, not me.
No, there was you're talking about after that auction, we started collecting stuff for a second auction.
Which nobody would never wanted to do, so we wound up giving it all away before we moved over here.
Oh, that is true. I remember that. Yeah, we gave all that shit away. Well, that was great. Thank you, Iraq. Bon voyage, Macho Man, Randy Savage.
What about the broad that wrestled?
The broad that wrestled?
About the wrestling.
The fucking one.
The fabulous moolah.
Oh, yeah.
The single female wrestler?
You know the one that was famous. What
China.
Fuck? Yeah.
And her giant clit.
I got four major autographs. They were all on TV guides.
Oh, yeah.
I got all of them autographed by the ones that
Did you actually get them signed, or were they just print that?
No, they're signed.
And now what?
Just in my basement. I was deciding who to give it to.
Mildred.
Eric or him. I didn't know.
I'll take him.
Yeah, but you've given me nothing. Eric has given me hope.
Oh.
I thought your documentary was funny.
All right. So far, you're in the running.
Great.
Whoever wins the challenge gets it. Whoever wins Friday.
I want to hear.
I'm in.
I want to hear Jimmy's idea of who needs to apologize in this
some
situation came up.
Someone owes an apology.
Someone owes an apology.
Because I just got handed this email by Roland.
Roland.
We are confirmed 10:05 to 10:30, Jim Norton, Studio 21, with Brian Johnson.
Oh, shit. Now, that must have just come out then. Somebody did some moving, shaking, and said, get things done. Jimmy's mad. They called the booking agent. Got this taken care of. Wow, it is amazing how fast they can get things done when Jimmy gets mad.
I think that this was already done.
What?
Now, this is why. I have to say this for myself.
Oops.
Did you notice? I didn't badmouth that woman. I said that there's no way she could know.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God.
You didn't badmouth
that woman. I didn't badmouth anybody personally. I just yelled about the system. Because I would have felt really stupid.
Because everyone came through.
I know that feeling.
The machine worked.
It did work. So my apologies for my outburst.
Wow.
I was wrong, and I'm stupid.
I have, never heard a real sincere apology.
That's an apology
sincere. That's sincere.
But that's why I did not throw anybody under the bus by name. Because you can't do that. I didn't throw her under the bus.
No.
I even said that she...
Do you jump the gun like that a lot in life?
If it... I've never seen a gun that I didn't leap over.
Yeah. Are you happy now?
Yes, but now I feel unprepared. No. I'm going to do a bad interview.
Is it today?
No, it's Wednesday.
Oh, Wednesday, of course.
So I'm so glad I showed a bit of restraint.
Yeah. Wednesday, we also have Malcolm McDowell coming in, right?
We do, we have him and Brian Johnson back-to-back.
That's a biggie. Back-to-back, are they doing a rom-com?
And a belly-to-back. I've been watching The Clockwork with commentary. It's all I've been watching.
That's good?
It's fucking, the 40th anniversary has so much stuff, and it's great.
What are they chit-chatting about?
Him and some other guy that he's just going through the entire film, and it's I've seen the movie so many times. I watched almost the whole thing last night with the commentary. They're just talking about all of the stories and his relationship with Stanley Kubrick. And there's all these weird, extras, Clockwork will look back, the making of Clockwork Orange. Malcolm McDowell does this thing in a room where he goes over, all these old contracts and all these old scripts. And really fucking amazing stories, man. I love the features.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I am on waiting for it to get signed.
I'm going to bring something for Malcolm to sign. I don't know what. I already got autographs from him and pictures. I want to get something special signed.
Like a piece of memorabilia?
Yeah, but, I want to get... here's what I want to get. A color photo from inside the Corova Milk Bar when they're all sitting there.
Ooh.
But I want that in color. Not a poster. A good-sized photo. Yeah. Really?
Do you have any more...
Take a screen cap. I mean, you got the Blu-ray, right? So just screen cap it. It's in excellent resolution. Bring it to your Photoshop and have them print it out.
I don't know how to screen cap and get it on my computer.
Oh, Jimmy, you're so sweet.
I'm just a boy. But I want them all sitting in the Corova. And they're all sitting there and he's holding up his milk.
His milk. The milk bar.
I have to watch that movie.
You will just...
I fell asleep.
You wouldn't understand it.
I was exhausted.
He would never understand.
No.
I would understand it. I'm fucking smart.
What's Are Gulliver? Really? Who's Gulliver?
No, he's a traveler.
It's great. What?
No, he answers the question. What kind of movies do you like, Rich? What do you usually watch?
I'm very wide. My spectrum is it goes from the Joy Luck Club to The Godfather. What movies do I? You know what?
You don't listen to music in your car, do you? You listen to talk radio.
Yeah.
Hate it.
What do you mean you hate? You do it all the time.
Nah, but it's comedy. It's
everyone
different.
Else sucks.
No, you do it on TV. Talk. But it's funny. Or it's comedically based. I'm talking about in the car.
Yeah.
Talk radio. I used to listen to it. Is unlistenable to me. I just can't listen to these fucking boring motherfuckers.
Droning.
Oh, my God. Oh, Democrats and Republicans and all this.
Political talk radio.
Oh, shut up.
No, there's no
humor to it at all.
And they're all kind of like fucking this. Predictable.
Yeah, exactly. They're just like this program. No humor.
On TV, I don't mind doing it.
But there is some that I think are... Years ago, I used to think Jay Diamond was great. Back in the, remember him?
Yeah.
He was good.
When he sang Sweet Caroline.
Bob Grant, I love.
Don't mind me.
Yeah. Like, of course it's going to lean to their sides, but you'll get lean. Some news.
It's boring. It's just listening to other guys' opinions. Who gives a fuck what they think? I used to listen to it, and I'm like, why do I care what this motherfucker thinks about anything? Gives a fuck.
They're very passionate about their.
And you know, the House has the Republicans and the Democrat Senate Committee and blah. Shut up. Gives a fuck.
What about sports radio?
Horrendous.
Yeah, that is bad. I don't listen to it. Can't fucking listen to a minute of sports radio.
It's terrible.
It's fucking I'll tell you what I've heard terrible. On the radio that I loved. There was an hour show on Sunday, or 2 hours of movie critics where they discuss movies. I love that kind of shit.
Listen to music.
What the fuck? I've heard it all. I've heard it already. At least, you know, what am I going to do? Oh, listen to Roundabout again? You know
something
what I mean?
Different. But music is more fun to listen to than a bunch of guys.
I listen to it once in a while. I got my greatest hits.
He just wants to find out and sound smart.
What are you talking about? So you're right. You learn. How else do you? Or
you don't learn, you though. You learn their opinions.
No, no. You'll hear the story, and then you make your own opinion.
But I do that on my fucking. But if you listen to the same talk
you
radio,
read the news.
You read the news, this or you go quicker. From different news sources.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not quicker. Go to Drudge Report. I mean, you go to Huffington Post. You go to a bunch of different sites.
No, you don't think they lean to
a bunch of? Yes. That's what I'm saying. A bunch of different sites.
Yeah,
all
so
from
I didn't
the same...
say I didn't listen to all different talk radio. Well, I don't listen just to the right. I'll listen to the left too.
Well,
I do. To get aggravated.
The left. How are you going to listen to that?
Do you yell at the radio?
Dull.
Do you ever get annoyed listening to people?
I used to get really annoyed listening to, what's his name? Fucking Kubi.
Talk radio.
He used to drive me fucking
nuts.
Just his fucking anti-white, self-hating Jew.
It just
I hated
didn't matter.
Him.
Whatever a black guy would do was totally fine. It was the white guy's fault. And he would get on the air and just talk about how awful the system is and how racist everybody is.
Him and Lynn Samuels, I used to hate her.
I cannot listen to talk radio. It is horrendous to me. Horrendous.
I don't know. I either put on that stupid shit hour after this show. I put on the shit hour is what it's called. Starring Sam Roberts. Or I just listen to the news. Like
yeah,
even
I'll
that, it's
that.
Not talk radio, but I put on 1010 Wins. I'll put on 88.
Yeah, I listen to that.
Yeah, because then I'm sick of listening to music. I really am.
Yeah,
I've gotten to the point where it's just like I don't care. What am I going to start listening to? A lot of new stuff. I'm done. I think I'm done.
Yeah.
Listening to there might be an occasional song or two where I'll be like, that's pretty good. I like that. But I think I've reached the point. That sucks. I'm kind of done.
I listened the other day, and I ended with Nectar, Remember the Future, and it just went on forever. And I said, you know what? I can't do this anymore.
The future.
Whatever. You know, all right, Empty Garden. All right, he's dead. We don't care.
Come here.
All right.
I'm trying to talk to you.
You know,
do you have satellite in your car, Rich?
Huh?
Do you have satellite radio?
No, I have it on my phone.
I
don't know how to work it.
You should get it in the car. It's fucking, honestly.
Oh, no, I know. When I rent
amazing,
a car, it
man.
Really is. Because I get to listen to, you know, the comedy channel, because that's always fun. And I'm wondering.
The 70s channel is great.
The comedy channels are the fucking. I'm going, how is this person on radio? They're the most.
Well, they
got to
fill time.
It's fucking horrendous.
They'll get some
real
shit.
The 70s, I listened to that.
You could listen to the fucking comedy just to hear comics that you hate or bad comics.
It is good sometimes to hear this shit comics, and you go, how is this?
When I get it on the road, I'll listen to Stern. He's fucking good in the morning. Have you listened to him in the morning?
Yeah, years ago. Yeah.
I listened in the afternoon.
It made me want to get into radio, and then once I got into radio, hard to listen. Doing it.
I listened recently because he takes these vacation blocks. Where they play this fucking like best of whatever history, and I knew for years what happened with Jackie, but I never heard it. And I knew like a long time would, and so I actually fucking heard that recently when Artie first came, and then when Artie had his breakdown. I heard all that shit, and it was fucking fascinating.
Pretty cool.
I knew the stories kind of, but to hear it actually unfolding, I'm like, Jackie, what are you doing?
What happened? It was about money, right?
Yeah.
He wanted more money?
Yes. But to hear their reactions or to hear these other... I'd never heard any of this
stuff. Yeah.
It was interesting.
But where did Artie come... Like, Artie... Like, he never really worked as a comic. He got TV, like, right away, didn't he?
I don't know. I honestly don't know.
He got, like, Mad TV or
something?
Yeah,
he was on Mad TV and a couple movies.
Because he was from Jersey, but you never knew... You never saw him working. Like, he was a headliner at a club. You know, he does TV, did a movie or so. And next thing you know, he's, you know, on the right-hand guy on Stern. He just came out of nowhere.
You were listening to Jackie and just going like, what are you doing?
There's
an equity to being on the show that goes beyond just the paycheck, you know, especially if you're a comic.
It's called filling a fucking theater reading joke books.
Yeah.
It's called filling a theater doing what the guy at the fucking, at the docks can do, okay?
I learned a lot from Jackie, though, before I ever met him. Because like that move that he made, and I understand. I've been, you know, we've all been tempted to go fuck this and walk. It's part of just doing any gig.
Never once.
But I remember. if you ever had a gig,
that was worth it, leaving.
But you start to think that way. But I'm like, they moved on without him, and they just went into a new era. Mm-hmm. And it's like I'm not bigger on this show than he was on that show, or and not just this, but anything else.
Jimmy,
but I'm saying,
of course you're not.
Yeah, I fell for it. So it's like, I actually did learn from him, man. Like, you can't, and he was there longer. Yeah. But I, you know what I mean? He's there 15 years.
Sometimes people get a little uppity and think a little too much of themselves and you know find themselves out the door going like, what the fuck did I just do?
Yeah, but you never want to think you're bigger than the game. Yeah.
No, but sometimes also people are so tired or they can't do it anymore and they don't have the courage to say, well, I'm quitting or I'm done. So this is a way, this is an out. It's a gamble going.
This is not a hard gig, though. Radio is not, it's like when you're just hanging out bullshitting, like this is work.
Yeah,
this is not
is
a
like,
hard
what?
Gig.
And then you
15
short,
years of he, you don't
home,
know his family. He
sleep.
Had a family. You don't know how it you know what it did to his family. Maybe he just said, I can't do this anymore. So let me go for broke. And if they say yes, then I. And if they say no,
my response to your awful devil's advocate argument.
That was a perfect.
Pause his face. That was great.
I'm so happy I have Brian Johnson. I'm really sorry I yelled. I feel very bad.
You know what? You got to base it on the track record. You have been fucked over. We all have. So you jumped the gun, but you had
justification. But I did see that email that said, hi, Ted, sorry.
Yeah.
So I, of course, reacted to that. Nobody told me that I had him, so it's fair to me.
Yeah.
Bless you. So I apologize.
I won't worry
about
it.
It's fucking 9:40 already?
I know. Can you believe that shit?
Time flies.
Can you believe that? We should take like a
quick break. And we'll come back and make love.
Listen, I need to
talk about some other shite.
Here's the thing in Buffalo.
Yes, Buffalo.
Well, I want to say one thing.
Nietzsche's.
Yeah, on June 17th. I'm booked to do one show, but I want to do two to make it worthwhile. Yeah. I want to
do something.
I want to get you.
Go ahead, just talk. Am I going to hit
Jerry's
you?
Rubbing,
just get your hands off
Jerry's
me, you
rubbing
fucking creepy.
Rich's leg, and Rich hates being touched.
I'm not hurting him, though. I'm not going to hurt
him.
That's
how tough it is. Derek doesn't like to be touched like that.
Derek doesn't like to be touched like that.
Almost identically.
Go ahead, talk.
Look at how, you're very uncomfortable.
Yeah, why? Nobody, really, at least I don't. You carry a gun.
I'd be very uncomfortable too. You're right.
But I wouldn't. That would never bother me if someone's just pointing me for a second. Yeah, just to annoy me.
Well, that's you.
Come on, let me just grab your dick.
He's trying to grab his dick. He's trying to grab his dick.
But it's not gay. It's like, come on.
No, it's just like, he grabbed his ass.
So I'm just touching it. He's all freaked out. Come here, baby.
Come here, baby.
Touch the mat, baby. Come here. So plug the gig.
Buffalo.
Buffalo at Nietzsche's.
June 17th and the 18th, somewhere in Toronto.
Toronto. Somewhere in Toronto.
On the 18th.
Exactly. In Toronto town.
Hopefully splattered at the bottom of the CN Tower.
In the big Canadian city.
Hopefully there's a bunch of Blue Jays nested on your eyes.
All right. Back in moments.
Sirius XM, the virus. The virus. The Opie and Anthony Show.
Hello, everybody. Opie and Anthony program. Opie's birthday today, and Opie took the day off. That's what he does on his birthday every year, I guess. To the chagrin of management, I haven't heard anything. Was it to the chagrin? There was no chagrining?
No, he has the days.
Yeah, but they like count them and stuff. I'm like, yeah, that's why I'm here today. Usually if Obi goes, oh, I think I'm taking off. I'm like, yeah, cool. I'm out too. Fuck it. But today I figured, it's an easy one. It's a Monday. Come in. Rich Voss, Jimmy Norton.
If you and Obi want to take a day off, me and Bonnie will come in and do the show.
You and Bonnie?
Yeah, we'd love to.
Yeah.
Can you do it with just Bonnie?
Yeah. Can Bonnie do it?
We could be very, very good.
Look, we've had both of you in, and it's very hysterical and very funny.
Yeah.
I like the way Bonnie interacts with you.
Yes.
It's very good. It's just a nonstop insult. But I would think it could turn into a promote everything Rich and Bonnie show.
No, I'm telling you.
Nah, you're right.
Promote
she doesn't like that.
Everything Rich and Bonnie show. Not just gigs. I mean, just like... Yeah. We're working on this.
No,
we got that.
We're working
can we
on one
pitch
thing
this?
And
we do
done.
That.
No, it was
how's that coming?
Off.
The documentary.
It's great. It's almost done.
Yeah.
She had the best line about DeRosa.
Are you going to Cannies with it?
She called DeRosa. She said DeRosa looks like a hanger from a back alley abortion.
Okay, because You got to bend it so it's got no shoulder. All right, I'll give her that.
No, the movie's great. We wouldn't promote. The movie's great. It's so fucking fun. I cannot wait for this thing to come out. I cannot wait to... You guys, you see, you're just going to... You know what? I can't wait to see my friends laugh. You guys were so fucking good in it.
Yeah, for the first time.
when you went fucking... When Bonnie goes, I'm doing a documentary on women, and you go, whoa. Oh, our women funny. You go, well, we can wrap that up in 3 frames. it's just
what did
so
I say?
And Artie Lang was fucking.
What
great.
Did I say?
Huh? Yeah. What does Jimmy say?
You're pretty good throughout it. Patrice's loud voice.
I asked him what I said. No
I
one
don't
does
remember
his name
the exact
other people.
Words. You said
yeah,
I,
you were good too, Ralph. You were good too,
Patrice. All you hear is without seeing his face first. They're not funny.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And real loud.
Oh, great.
It's just so. And Keith is fucking. It's everyone is so fun. Sarah Silverman is beyond
have
funny.
Have you seen anyone name drop like this in his life?
It's fucking. You asked me about amazing. It. You fucking. I'm telling you who's funny.
I know, but
well, I'm name dropping using Keith Robinson. That ought to help.
Oh, yeah,
what
that's
if
true.
I want to host a cellar at 4 a.m? Okay. All right. I'm just saying who's
touché,
funny.
Touché.
Okay. And I didn't use the big stars. I didn't
go to Yankee Stadium.
Yeah, something where you the LaGuardia Airport. Or it's like, hey, we had you could say touche.
Well, when does it come out?
Well, here's the deal.
Uh-oh.
We're almost done editing. We have someone who's going to compose now. Good price.
What is that thing on the bridge of your nose?
What, this right here?
Yeah.
My finger?
No, the fucking scar.
I was trying to...
Where? Right here?
Move your hand. You see it, Ant? Have you seen that bridge?
No. Can't see it from here.
Really?
I'm serious. I want to know what it is. It's weird. It's like a gray crusting.
It was probably...
Jesus.
You're not taking pictures of my
For
face.
For you? No. Why not? You're a fucking entertainer. No. Who cares? Quote, unquote.
No. I'm very
so,
funny
so when I say when's it coming out?
Well, who knows?
I just want to know, like, kind of, do you have a ballpark? Do you say
his mouth?
What a
park for balls. What do you think? I'm going to take a photo.
No, I don't know. Anthony. No, because I, you know how many
I'm
fingers to count?
I won't
Twitter it. Twitter it.
I won't. I'm telling you, I won't.
You want to show Anthony?
Yeah, he's trying to take a picture of Rich Voss. I don't know.
It was a blackhead that...
All right, since Rich won't let me take a picture of it, if anybody has any photos of Rich's face that you can zoom in on...
Oh,
yeah, no, you can take a picture. No.
You need a picture of Rich's face.
And I was a name drop. I didn't sit here and go, oh, Joan Rivers was great.
Oh, she's in it.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, or
Chelsea Handler.
She's not.
Oh.
Oh, really? Do you think... We got Wanda Sykes.
Oh, Wanda.
We got fucking Sarah. We got Joan. We got... Rosie, we got fucking Joy Behar.
How was
Susie
Rosie
Essman.
To deal with?
I didn't interview. I wasn't there. Bonnie was there and said she was great for an hour. She was. She
well,
talked
I
to Bonnie
see
for
it.
An
Two
hour.
Two girls just yapping
you know
to
what
each
it
other.
Is? And you can ask them, when you get a comic talking about comedy, they'll talk about it forever.
Yeah.
You know, Rita Rudner was so nice.
Rita Rudner.
She's
Stop.
One of the best fucking joke writers in the business.
No, she's. I hear she earns really well.
Yeah.
But I never found her very funny
at all.
Well,
you know, first of all, I'm surrounded by cameras. This is what it's going to be like when I walk down the red carpet.
Oh, please.
Exactly.
Michael Ian Black, fucking, what do you call it? Tom Arnold.
Tom Arnold.
The guy from fucking Jimmy Carr from England, who's fucking funnier than almost anybody.
Who's the biggest star, would you say, that is featured in this? Seinfeld?
No, either, Chris Rock or Joan Rivers. Or
Chris Rock.
Dane is in it. Lisa Laminelli's in it. Everybody's in it, you know.
Move your hand.
Leave me alone, you fucking freaks.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? I'm not an animal.
Everyone's trying to take pictures now of Rich Voss's face.
And this awful fucking gray nose thing. What is that?
I'm going to be 54.
He just comes out with, I'm going to be 54.
Hopefully not.
That's nice. That's nice.
That is. You don't like that jinx thing when people say shit like that?
No.
How have you been lately?
Make Sam smell it.
You're a hypochondriac, right?
Yeah.
A little bit. How have you been?
Good.
What's troubling you these days? You think you got a brain tumor or something?
No, well, my sister's husband got sick, and I said, what was wrong? And she started explaining, I hung up.
Because you just start like, thinking, oh, I don't want to hear this shit.
I started thinking, well, I have it.
I'll do that sometimes on, doctor shows and stuff. Or if they, like, a commercial comes on, 88, and it's like, this is for the American something society, some disease, and I'm like, if you felt headaches or blurred vision or and I'm just like, but I don't hear, but I can't punch out quick enough.
I know.
Because like one less thing I need to worry about.
I'd rather listen to the Cars for Kids commercial.
1-877 Cars.
Can't read about health because they make it so.
It's too vague, right?
It's too vague that you think, you know, of course.
You got everything.
Really? If I piss in the middle of the night, guess what that means? I got to piss.
Well, if you piss like a lot. Or if it has some kind of a isn't there like a smell if it smells like fucking it's like too sweet or something that you have something diabetes maybe
oh, Jesus,
I don't know but I would go smelling my piss.
Wait,
how does that asparagus get in there so fast?
I
love it.
Right when you
eat it though, in your piss.
We have a clip of Voss butchering a word. Can we hear it?
Oh no!
I don't know. Chris Rock or Joan Rivers or
Chris Rock.
Dane is in it. Lisa Laminelli's in it. Everybody's in it.
Lisa Laminelli.
Whatever her name is. Laminelli.
Lisa Laminelli?
You know
Lisa
who I was talking about.
Laminelli.
And he asked about it.
He meant lemon jelly.
I wasn't going to talk about it at all, but you brought it up. I'm not here to promote. I'm not about that.
Oh, what are you implying? That he is?
No. Who? No, you asked me about the movie.
Of course I did.
I
wanted
just
to know, like, is it by next, this time next year, will it be out?
Well, you'll know because you won't see me. Yeah, I hope so.
Oh,
I don't know if I'm going to.
You're going to go further into obscurity?
First of all, I don't know if we're going to try to get in festivals or sell it out, right? I don't know. I got to wait till it's done and bring it to my lawyer.
Some kind of distribution.
My lawyer who won't answer the phone because I haven't made him a dime ever.
This is between Sam trying to take a picture of Rich's face and Jimmy just groping at his dick and his ass.
I'm just trying to touch his arm even at one point or his stomach, just like his little chest. There you go. It's nice. He's all fidgeting.
The fucked up thing is,
it's like watching Brundle fly talk.
Yeah. What's that?
The way you're moving around.
You two have fucked in the same girl.
We didn't touch.
Yeah, but that's just it. But it's like, so he can't even touch your arm.
You don't want
you just watched him banging away on some creepy little thing.
Creepy guy touching me. Look at him.
But he's one of your best friends.
I don't like him.
No, not so much. I really like this guy.
Come on. Yeah. Oh, man.
What's going on with the... Because obviously the shit hour is starting very, very shortly.
Yeah.
What's the deal with Ronnie and Fez?
Well...
What do you know of this situation?
About what situation?
I don't know, because I won't get specific unless you are privy to say anything, but I think you know what I'm talking about.
Well, are we talking about the question that I posed to them or the statement that Ron made?
Give me a little of both.
Well, the question that I posed to Ron was the question that Opie asked me to pose to Fez, which is about the Nut House.
Right.
And Ron said that it was under consideration, but this time it would be a longer stay, like maybe 2-3 years.
2-3 years.
So he said, though, he would continue Ron and Fez and wait to see how long it would take people.
From, like, a crazy house?
No, like, he would do it by himself.
And then just wait to see how long it took
people. And wait to see how long people...
Oh, really?
Yeah, like, he would just keep doing the show.
Realize that there's no Fez in the room.
That's what he said, yeah.
Is Fez on medication?
I think he is, yes.
All right, so he sounds like he's... Is he always just having breakdowns?
Yeah, he has very bad anxiety. And he breaks down a lot.
Why does he cry so much?
I think it has to do with the anxiety. They're
probably the anxiety. Yeah, gets them all nervous.
Worse, yeah.
You get that, Rich?
Are you crazy? We just said that last time.
Yeah, but you still get it just as bad.
I mean, click in and click off. Anxiety is fucking horrible. Because it can get to the level where you're so disorientated and it turns into panic.
What happened?
Disoriented.
Disoriented.
Disoriented, I said.
That's okay.
After you know, and you, it's bad anxiety.
And what,
man,
you can't concentrate
on
it?
Yeah, well, no, you just, because you think you're going crazy, because you're going, why the fuck is this happening? Why is my body? And then you feed into it and it turns into panic.
Oh, it's, you know, the old rolling snowball thing, huh? Yep.
I guess if that's how you would compare it to a rolling snowball.
You know, gathering up, it just becomes a monster.
That's what I'm saying.
Unless you could nip it in the bud.
Yeah.
You got to the point, because how long have you had it? How many years have you been dealing with that?
Ooh, 21, 53.
Ever since you stopped doing drugs?
No, I didn't. I stopped at 28, but I started with anxiety at 21. But it goes away and comes and goes. Now I'm getting it now that I'm talking about it.
Do you have anxiety because you've got a big stomach now?
Oh, God. All right. Why did...
Yeah.
Take a picture of that.
The rituation. He's showing his abs.
Does it? Yeah, Rich is showing his abs. Rich, do you really get it just by talking about it?
Yeah. You start feeling like you're outside of yourself. And you're...
You look at your hand, it looks weird.
Why do you panic so much?
Huh?
What do you mean outside of yourself?
What the fuck? Calm down with the questions.
What do you mean?
I'm trying to give him an anxiety
attack. Yeah, what do you mean? Your fucking Lou Reed jacket. We want to know what you mean.
Okay. What do you need? What do you need a picture of? You want some abs?
This is...
Yeah, show me.
Hold on.
You get very distracted, Rich, where you can't really talk.
Okay.
Rich has to lean into his his showing of the abs. He's taking his shirt off. What is that? With the never again friggin' Star of David tattoo. Yeah, what a...
Turn, dummy. I'll take a good
You're shot. Not supposed to be tatted up as a Jew.
His shirt's off.
And he's got his gold diamond Star of David around his neck. You're like super
Hold
Jew.
Hold on, dummy. Make your fucking abs.
He's fucking super Jew. He's posing. Oh, look, he's pulling his pants down a little.
Hold on.
Oh, my God, he's got payas coming out of the top of his pants.
All right, I got the nose. Here's the picture I just took of his abs.
He got a great picture of his face. Hold on. What the fuck are you doing?
I'm in great shape.
I'm in great shape. Oh, that was funny, man.
What is it?
God damn. I just never understand that. How old is that Star of David tat on your arm?
Huh?
How old is that tat? When did you get that?
Oh, fuck. 18 years ago?
And isn't there a fucking... Did the tat artist, like, go, I can't do that?
Why?
Because you're not supposed to tat up a
the
Jew.
Fucking, the tat artist are fucking putting swastika and SS symbols on people.
Well, now, you know, take the bad with the good. Oh, that I don't know. Maybe he was squeezing.
What, here?
Yeah.
Were you squeezing?
It's just a little scar. What the fuck?
I got a good picture of it.
Jimmy's fascinated with it. He just knows every curve of your face and body.
That's how when we caress each other. That's what we do. We, go,
we caress. What do you mean? I try to caress you. Keep rolling out of the bed in your silk pajamas.
Oh, Bonnie. Speaking
Left
of promoting,
you. Came to her
speaking
senses.
Of promoting, she wanted me to brag and show this.
Oh,
hold
oh, this
on.
A picture papers? Of the.
no, I.
Hey, young captain.
She made me a pie yesterday. She made an apple pie.
You I really took a picture of an apple
she
pie
did.
She made.
She see. Did. Oh. She wanted.
It's great. So the one from see. Thinner.
She what?
The one from Thinner.
The black.
Yeah, except there's fucking gas in it.
Because I was playing golf yesterday and she cooked a lovely dinner and made a pie.
Yeah, believe me, that's got rat poison in it. She's like, go ahead, eat it. Golfing Jew, enjoy.
Yeah.
Yep.
You golf a lot. You're out of that house a lot.
I fucking played great yesterday.
You
I had
leave
a
her
meltdown.
Alone a lot?
Two over par in the front nine, 38. Ooh. Then a meltdown on the back, 38, 48.
Oh, see what happens.
What time do you start playing?
When I get to the first tee.
Now, boy, what time is that?
A whole different time. Yesterday I played after 3. I get the discount after 3. And I wanted to spend the day with the kid. I took the kid to the park.
So you went and just played golf from 3. How far is it from your house?
5-6 miles. I played from 3 to 7.
Well, 4 hours?
Oh, a little it takes louder. Forever, yeah.
That's how
a
long...
quick round.
Golf takes forever sometimes. You can be out there 6 hours sometimes if you're behind like some shitheads.
Oh, I'll walk
ain't
off.
Fucking moving. Really?
Oh, yeah, I can't play that
You
long.
Love golf, don't you?
Yes.
Do you ever try to play through and people are like
I
assholes
do it all the time.
About it?
I do it all the time. So if they get mad, I'll just go in front of them. It depends if I'm by myself and I want to get done, I'll cut blow off two holes and come back to them later.
Oh,
I just
really?
Fly. Yeah, I don't have time
get
to wait.
Golf,
you know,
man.
And I stop biting myself.
You ever drive into somebody because they haven't been moving?
No, but it's just true. Funny. I don't know. I can't even believe.
I've seen that.
These guys hit up on us.
Hey! Someone yells back at you like, "Hey, but fucking move!"
I did one time. I hit the ball as far as I ever hit it, and it bounced, and it rolled on the green on a par four. I hit it like 280. No, it was like 320, but it rolled like. And they're yelling at me, "You're on the green, I'm on the tee, you should be
great
clapping,
shot,
you fucking assholes.
You should be saying great
wow.
shot.
Yeah, you're yelling.
Hey!
You're jealous.
Step on your ball, kick it off the green.
One time these Asian guys hit up on us, and they go, "Hey, have you seen my ball?" I go, "Yeah, it's on the slope." But I meant to say it was on the hill.
it's a great racist joke.
But I didn't mean it. Yeah, man, I love golf. Are you kidding? I'm playing this Wednesday at a TPC course.
Rich loves golf.
Just fucking what I play.
TPC?
Yeah.
What's that?
It's a fucking tournament players. I don't know. TPC, what it stands for.
If I had the energy, I would come up with some kind of.
That's where say. Indians live. See?
TPC.
TPC.
What does TP stand for? Tournament Player
Champion. The Champion. Players
Champion. Yeah. That's a tournament. What's TPC stand for?
Yeah.
The.
Are you going to tell me?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you. The.
What?
Players Champion.
Yeah, but all the courses that are called TPC courses.
Yeah, what about them?
They're endorsed by the Players Championship.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
He knows a lot about golf.
Yeah. Well, really?
I just know.
You used to play?
Very horribly.
Oh, really?
I haven't played in years. I played for like a few years, but never got good at it because I didn't play enough. So
yeah,
it was like some of those days you'd go out and be like, "I fucking finally got it down. I rule." And then the next time you're out, it's like, "What am I, fucking chick?
It
suck, shanking it, stink." Yeah. I always said there's a rule too. When we talk about golf, for more than 5 seconds, the show's over. So, Rich, you're going to be at Nietzsche. Nietzsche's.
Yeah. June 17th in Buffalo. Looking forward to coming back to Buffalo. One of my favorite cities.
Buffalo. Well, of course it is. You're playing there.
Well,
Your favorite cities are always the one that you're going to.
No, that's not true.
At
Buffalo, a lovely lady I used to fool around with years ago, back in the day.
Buffalo, not known for their hot girls.
You could always find one somewhere.
Oh, those dumb accents.
Ugh.
Hey, yeah, sure. You could lick me on the old nip. Oh yeah, go on, put that in your mouth, lick the old nipple, have some wings and watch some hockey.
And I'll be back.
I'm wearing a nice hockey jersey. Oh yeah, why don't you lick the ball?
And I'll also be back in Utah sometime.
Yeah, the town of Utah.
It's my favorite place.
My favorite accent, which is one of your favorites, is Philly.
What's going on?
Yeah, what's going on?
Get some water. Go down here and do the wash.
What's going on?
What's going on with you? Oh, it's fucking horrible. That South Jersey Philly accent. It's fucking terrible.
Awful.
I'd rather talk to the business end of a shotgun than somebody with that fucking accent. Oh, there's the ex-governor.
Yeah. That's Jesse Ventura talking with
And him. I'm plugging
Watcher, man.
The fact that I happily... Mm-hmm. We'll be interviewing Brian Johnson from my Boneyard show, as well as Opie and Anthony. So a thank you to the talent department. There was an email glitch, which is why I was bothered.
Glitch.
I was wrong.
Yes.
My apologies for doubting you.
Yes.
Thank you.
You've turned that frown upside down, my friend.
Wow, this town got really fucked up, man.
Joplin.
Holy, I wonder how far it is from Kansas City.
I fucking care.
It's I can't. I'm in Kansas City in two weeks.
They live there and...
That's fucked up, though.
Now, did this happen during when it was supposed to be the Armageddon?
No, it happened
this
morning.
Must have been like, holy shit.
Yeah.
That happened this morning.
Yeah.
It's fucking horrible, man. Just people, you're living your normal daily life, and boom, a tree falls on your house going, what did you do this to my brother?
Yeah, but... Oof. Bad things happen all the time.
Huh?
Doesn't matter where you live.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Planes hit your buildings, you get an earthquake, you get floods, tsunamis, radiation. And tornadoes.
See you tomorrow.
Have a great life.
Who's that chick?
That's Sensational Sherry.
That's Jesse, right?
That's Jesse Ventura. Yeah, Sensational Sherry's dead.
She's dead?
Talk to Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan, what you gonna do when the madness runs wild on you?
Yeah!
This guy's macho.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, wow. Mental, the guy at the end looked like a monster.
That was the Macho Man.
That's the dead Macho Man.
No, the one on the left?
Yeah.
No.
Yes, yeah. It was.
He looked like a monster.
Yes.
Well, he was a monster.
Was. Look at what's on his nose there?
I'll take a picture, Jimmy. all right, look. I've had it with Monday. I'm done.
Why didn't I fucking go with my first instincts and go back to bed?
Of course, Sam Roberts, wonderful Danny Ross, and Travis. Thank you all. Stay tuned for the shit hour.
Lots of Macho Man promos.
Lots of Macho Man
promos. About an hour's worth.
On the shit hour. And maybe a little Ronnie B stopping in.
Well, he said very mysteriously on Thursday, he told me he was not going to do the Ronnie and Sammy Sweetheart show anymore.
Right, because I guess Fezzy had a little bit of an issue with it.
That's what he said, but I can't get to the bottom of what this issue is.
Is it a work?
Maybe Fez Marie will come in and do the show. I would love that too.
Well, we'll
see what happens. It's unpredictable. Like the Macho Man.
I'll be listening. And thank you for tuning in.
You can stick around if you want.
Yeah, stick around. And
No, me?
Yeah. I thought you were talking to the listeners.
I mean, you stick around, too.
No. I'm not going to be sticking around. No. Later. Take it easy, everybody. I'll see you tomorrow.